any hockey arena anywhere where that's not a highlight reel goal.
For over 75 years, CFAR has been providing play-by-play coverage of the good guys, and the tradition continues.
Open up, they score! There's your hat-trick goal! And the Flint-Warren Bombers will take the lead!
Live on CFAR 590. 1029 CFAR and all around the universe on FlynnFlonOnline.com.
Kids up on a backhander! Oh, big save there! Celine Dion, nothing but glove!
30 seconds.
By Harbin Laser Hill, that was a beauty!
And now here with the call of the action.
Look at this! Kenny Marquardt's come over and him and Paul gonna get out of it?
The one and only.
And how about that?
Mr. Rob Hart.
You're on.
All righty, thank you very much, and welcome to the Whitney Forum as we're set for another great installment of Creighton Furniture Flint Flon Bomber Hockey. It'll be the Humboldt Broncos here tonight. The Broncos fresh off back-to-back wins in LaRonde the past couple of nights. The Bombers, of course, fresh off a kind of four-game winning streak going now after they lost that game in overtime in Melville a week ago tonight. We're able to respond with a win in Yorkton, of course, beat the Belfort Mustangs on Wednesday, and then, of course, victory here last night. So I guess a three-game winning streak since the game against Belton, although they still got a point and didn't lose in regulation. Anyway, the Humboldt Broncos bring, of course, a totally different brand of hockey to the building. They played a couple of weeks back, and I know talking to the respective coaches, Mike Reagan for the Bombers, Scott Barney for the Broncos, the players, it was just hockey at a whole different level. Nothing against Yorkton, nothing against Melford, who's a pretty solid club in their own right. Melville, all those teams, but the Broncos, the Bombers, I would think the two best skating teams in the league. And again, nothing against North Battleford. I haven't seen much of them, but they didn't appear to be as quick to me as I saw these two teams from the showcase. So Austin Mattis is back with us. Of course, Austin took care of the controls on Flow TV for us on Wednesday against Melford. And at times, Flint Flon really dominated play. But you were with me for one of those Humboldt games a couple weeks ago, and they easily could have been on the right end of the score as opposed to the wrong end. Flint Flon will be tested and tested very well here tonight.
Oh, you know what, Robin? It's been a very common theme throughout this season so far. You know, you look at the scores and it looks like the Bombers are blowing teams out of the water, but in reality, that 5-1 game, 5-2 game, even yesterday's game against Yorkton when it was 8-4, it may look like that on the scoreboard, but if you watch the game, it's a totally different story. Most of these teams are neck and neck each time. So it's going to be a great one today for sure, and I'm just hoping the Flint Flon Bombers are going to be able to come out with some kick in their step here, because they've really been struggling on their starts recently.
And yes.
Talking to Carter Anderson and Coach Reagan, they said that's one thing they've really been trying to instill these past couple weeks, because honestly, even over the past 5 to 10 games, they've been coming out really, really slow. And even though Humboldt's on their third game and a third night here tonight, if the Bombers come out slow, Humboldt's going to take advantage, and that's where they're going to find some problems.
Well, I told you, and you were, of course, offering the board for us last week, and, you know, a week ago Friday, they gave up 3 goals against Humboldt the first 6 minutes. Three goals against Yorkton the first 6 minutes. 2 goals against Yorkton the first 4 minutes on Sunday. And you can't do that against teams like this. And I got to go back to that Humboldt series, and we talked just that little bit of an inch between winning and losing. Had chances to pounce on Flint Flon, could never get that important goal. Good starts. They scored the first goal on Friday, answered the Bombers' first goal on Saturday pretty quickly, but couldn't get the power play going. Anytime they needed that extra little push to kind of get in the driver's seat, and I can go back the last several years in the playoffs, they haven't been able to do that. Flint Flon's done a really good job of taking care of their own end. That's been kind of the difference, I think, between these two teams. It's been so tight. And the Broncos have never been able to deliver that knockout punch.
Well, I think that's kind of been the case with most teams in the league when the Bombers play them. When the Bombers see a team make a mistake, they're really able to capitalize it. I'd say a good 70 to 80% of the time. Most other teams, it's about 40-50, so that's where the Bombers really have the advantage. But if the Bombers are making lots of mistakes, well, then that's where they find themselves the problem. And I honestly, in yesterday's game against Yorkton, I think there was a little too many mistakes. And even against past weekend in Yorkton and Melford, and even those last Humboldt games, I think they're a great team, but they do make a little too many mistakes, and they're lucky that teams haven't pounced on them yet for it.
Well, I said it on that last road trip, and I mentioned to Mike on the post-game report that I saw them make more mistakes that road trip in those 3 games combined than I had all year. But, you know, it's going to happen. I mean, you're not going to be great every single night you play. I guess the one key for Flint Flon, even amongst the mistakes, they still find ways to win games, and that is the marking of a good hockey club. Flint Flon right now sitting, of course, 22-1-2. Getting ready for the Humboldt Broncos. We said fresh off those 2 wins against LaRonde, a very good record in their own right, at 17-5-2-1. Little extra motivation for the Broncos. last road game before Christmas tonight, last visit to the Whitney Forum this season tonight, so look for them to be at their best.
Oh, you know, and they always come here to play, and like you mentioned, the last series was essentially playoff hockey, right? Some of the fastest hockey we've seen so far, so this Humboldt team is definitely going to come out to play, and like I said, the Bombers really got to hone down on having a good start. And if you're humble, you really want to take advantage of the Bombers' mistakes, unlike they did last time. If they can take advantage this time, I think we'll have a really close and exciting game.
You know, we heard a little bit of the montage going in there. Rafael does such a great job putting those together. Harmon Lazenhulme, congratulations to him, the SJHL goalie of the month. Harmon Lazenhulme entering play tonight, and I remember the one time that seemed to be the big concern of everybody was it was the goaltending going to hold up. Harmon Lazenhulme's been on just an incredible tear. He's got the best numbers in the league entering tonight. He leads the league in wins with 15. He's got the best goals against a 2.11 and the best save percentage of 926. So he was just named the SJHL Goalie of the Month. Congratulations to him. And Justin Lee's, of course, a factor in last night's game. He leads the league in points. He had two more points last night, including his league-leading 22nd goal of the year. Congratulations to him on the Player of the Month. And how about Carter Anderson? A five-point performance, four goals. He was beaming, one of the best power forwards in the league. So lots of reasons to be pumped up and excited. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to get to the respective coaches, but looking forward to this one tonight. Always a marquee matchup when the Bombers and Broncos hook up, and we're looking forward to, of course, bringing this one to you once again from the Whitney Forum here on 102.9 CFAR and FlintFawnOnline.com.
Maybe even a nice gift from Teresa in the business office. Tis the season to be jolly at Great North GM in the paw.
You're on.
Welcome to our SJHL Coaches Show. Mike Reagan, the head coach GM of the Bombers, joins us. Mike, solid effort last night. It just seemed as the game kept going on, the more and more momentum you had. And what can you say, Carter Anderson, a 5.94 goals, one of the most explosive players in the league for sure.
Yeah, he's been awesome. I think that his confidence just keeps growing, and, you know, obviously he's having fun, and you can see it out there. You know, I think that power play unit is really embracing each other now and working together, and they're getting, you know, results. And, I mean, that's big for our hockey club. You know, with momentum and everything like that, I thought, you know, we score on that 5-on-3, which is nice to execute early on in a hockey game, but then we kind of got a little bit complacent, and, you know, the next thing you know, we're down 2-1. But, to come into the dressing room tied at 2, I think, was huge for us.
Well, and like I said, as a game, for whatever reason, you look back at these last three Yorkton games, the third period, you've really taken it to them. That's been a big difference in all three of these games.
Yeah, we take a lot of pride in, you know, trying to win in the third, you know, making sure that teams, you know, trying to skate with us throughout the game is where, you know, it's really going to pay off for us in the third period. And we, you know, our depth can kind of take over, and we're able to roll four lines, and, you know, that's tough to do for other teams to keep up, you know. So you know, I think that we've done a pretty good job in the third period, like you mentioned, against Yorkton. I think that's kind of where we've separated ourselves over the three games, and, you know, it's a big 2 points for us.
You know, one of those games last night, it's a game you had to really watch just to see what guys were doing, because Jacob Vaukler didn't have a goal last night, Mike, but that's as good as I've seen him play in the last several weeks.
Yeah, I think that Cole mentioned to him on the bench that, you know, he's not getting rewarded for how well he's playing. And, you know, he made a beautiful fake shot and pass to Andy on, I think, his fourth goal there. And then last week or against Melfort, you know, a beautiful again, fake, and then he slides it over to Justin and empty net for him. So, you know, Vox has been really good. Like, I think what people don't understand is he doesn't have to show up on the score sheet to be effective. Every night he's one of our best players.
Humboldt again tonight, Mike. You've seen him twice. You beat him both games here a couple of weeks back. They had good starts they couldn't bury, but when you look back at those games, what do you think was the difference, how you were able to prevail in both those games?
I just think we stuck with it, you know, and, you know, I think that we've got some high-end game breakers that, you know, as time goes on, you can't shut them down all night, or if you do, you know, someone else is stepping up. And, you know, I think that we just stuck with the system and bought in, and eventually it paid off for us. So we know they're a very good hockey team. We know that they're hungry. You know, this is the last time they're in the Whitney Forum during the regular season here, and then we've got to play three in Humboldt. And, you know, we've played each other a lot over the last 3 years, so very familiar with each other's styles. And, you know, we got a lot of respect for Humboldt. And, you know, I think the biggest thing is we just got to stay focused on what we have to do and not worry too much about what they're doing.
You know, you mentioned explosive guys. We talked about Carter Anderson, but your captain, Justin Lees, leads the league in scoring, Mike. But he just controls the play out there. I mean, he grabs the puck, and he's just able to create lots of open ice. He makes everybody so much better. When's the last time you saw a guy of his caliber and skill level on your team?
Yeah, it's hard to say. You know, I mean, we've had some good players here for sure. But Justin's got this confidence that, you know, maybe is unmatched. And you can see that it continues to grow. You know, I think that early on in the year, he wasn't having the success that he was hoping for and that sort of thing. And he's been an extremely motivated player from day one coming here. He's got one thing on his mind, and, you know, so far he's done a great job at leading this team. And, you know, whenever we need, you know, some momentum to swing our way, usually it's Justin that's providing that for us. So, you know, we got a lot of great players, and you know, he's not the only guy that contributes in that fashion, but he's done a heck of a job.
Well, you mentioned a lot of good players, a lot of depth. Mike, is it tough to decide who plays and who's in and out game to game? I'm thinking that can't be easy.
Yeah, we've had a tough time here over the last little bit with some guys getting healthy. You know, Eags is back healthy, Niven's healthy. You know, Ole's been battling a minor injury. You know, so that's why he didn't play last night. And Piccinino, you know, is had an injury there. He looked great last night. You know, I think it's one of those things that our guys just really got to understand. If you're going to be a part of a special team or a special group, there's sacrifices that you have to make. And so far, so good. We just keep telling the guys, make our jobs hard to make those decisions. If you're making it easy on us, you know, that's probably not a good thing.
Sounds good to me, Mike. Good luck against the Broncos here tonight.
Thanks very much, Robert.
Mike Reagan, the head coach of the Bombers here on 102.9 CFER and FlinFlonOnline.com.
Claire. Bailey Homes provides a ready-to-move home as unique as you and your family. From the expertise in the planning, the quality of the build, to the care of the move, let Bailey Homes make your dream home a reality. All customized to fit your needs, they allow you to take the stress out of home construction and spend more time making everlasting memories. Family owned and operated with experiences in the North, visit bailey-homes.ca or call 204-903-5220.
You're on.
SJHL Coaches Show continues. Scott Barney joins us. Scott, fresh off two wins in LaRonge. I know LaRonge maybe struggled a little bit this year, but saying that's still a pretty tough building to win hockey games in, and especially back-to-back nights.
Yeah, I thought LaRonge battled hard. Like, obviously, they came off two wins there in Kindersley, and you know what? I think in the third period, we got both wins. It was a game until then, and obviously, I think last night was just down to the last 4 or 5 minutes. So, you know what? Good to get those wins here and get over to Flin Flon for a big match here today.
Well, your last road game here before the Christmas break, it's safe to say you guys want this one bad.
Yeah, I thought like those first two games could have went either way, right? I thought Hume was great in net, Lies was great with some good plays in Anderson as well, and obviously a deep team in Flin Flon here, and I think we just got to play physical and you know what, play hard for 60 and see where the chips lie.
Well, we talked a little bit about this last time you were here too. You had really good starts, especially on the Friday game, but when you had those opportunities, you're missing that big goal to get a multiple lead. They were able to answer your first goal despite your great start. And we talked about that, Scott. That'll be a big factor, I think, again tonight. Pouncing on this team when you get the opportunity.
Yeah, obviously you got to take advantage of it, or you know they will, right? I thought they did, and the game's great. And you know what, for us, we got to get inside. You know what, Flin Flon does a great job defending, keeping guys to the outside. So you get your first shot, you got to get in there for the second, right? So I think that's a big key tonight is whether our team can clear the front of the net quicker. Probably going to win the game.
We know one thing: both these teams could skate. And I know talking to you the last time you were here, and the Bombers' perspective as well. Both these teams really enjoy playing each other, and this is some really good hockey.
Yeah, I love it. Look forward to it. And, you know, if you could play 56 of these games, it'd be awesome, right? I think it makes your teams better in the end. Good competition, right? And it seems like we see each other in the playoffs every year anyways. And looking forward to the matchup. I'm really excited for it here today.
I know that everybody's goal is to win the league, and you got a great team, but you really got stepping stones. You got a lot of good young players. Bryson Thu, Van Blerikom, Motu, the list goes on and on. Could be the making for a pretty special team here for you guys for the next few years, Scott.
Yeah, hopefully, right? And a lot of young guys now move on, right, to USHL and stuff like that. And that's our goal, right? is move these guys on to the next level. We're a development league, and if you can develop them through winning, I think that gets more opportunities for them, and hopefully we can continue to do that here for years to come in Humble.
Have these young guys gone beyond expectation for you so far this year?
Not really, right? There's we did a lot of research on them. They're all a really coachable group. Obviously, you can get some emotions high or low, and sometimes you take our foot off the gas pedal and cost us, and seen it a few times this month, and we've been basically on the road the whole month. But, I know the guys are excited here for the last five games. Obviously, this one, circling the calendar, is a big one, too, and we'll see how the legs are here tonight with our guys.
Obviously, you like your group. The only team in the league that hasn't brought in any players. Your lineup you began the season with is the lineup you have here today.
Yeah. You know what? We talked about it a few times. Hey, guys, like, you know what? We lose a few games here and there. But you know what? Our guys battle, compete in practice. Our leaders lead. Our young guys push them every day. It's hard not to keep them around here. And you know what? Hopefully they do that here tonight and keep us guessing some more. And obviously we got room to add. We only have 5 or 6 20-year-olds. For me, really, age isn't really a big factor. It's just good hockey players. And we also have good people, and that's important to me as well.
Quickly, Scott, I know you want to get out there and get warm-ups going here. I think the one thing besides the speed of your club that I like, balance. You have balance everywhere. Goaltending, you got two guys you can go to. You got a really good back end, and you got a lot of skilled forwards with speed. Is this the most balanced team you've had since you've had this club?
Yeah, I would say it's the best two-way team, right? Maybe not the offensive firepower we've had in the past, but we got some good balance for the four lines, like you said, and really like our D-core. You know, we got 8D that can play. Obviously, they're not always happy with some guys coming in and coming out, but this weekend we've moved out a couple 20-year-olds. It was kind of a planned thing, and guys need rest at some point too. But, yeah, really happy with our balance. Goalies give us a chance to win every night, and we can't ask for much more.
Fun Flan here again tonight. You almost get the feeling that they're on a collision course in the playoffs again, don't you?
Yeah, 100%. Rob, seems like every year, and, I look forward to it. You know, it's always a good trip up here, good hospitality. Fans are right intense into the game. They love supporting their Bombers, and that's what you want to see. And I know our players love doing it, and I know the Bombers players must be excited to play in front of their fans too as well.
Good to see you, Scott. It'll be the last time we see you before Christmas, so a very Merry Christmas to you and your family. Good luck at the World Junior A Challenge, and good luck against the Bombers tonight.
Thanks, Rob. Always a pleasure with you.
God keep our land glorious and free. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee. Oh, Canada, we stand on guard for thee.
And nicely done again by Mr. Bob Negum. And boy, the fans, I think they're jacked up. We got the indication from both the coaches tonight, Austin. Big one, and we thought it felt like a playoff atmosphere. The last time the Broncos were here, I think you're really going to feel it tonight. I think about it being Humboldt's last visit to Flint Pond for the regular season and their last road game before Christmas. It's going to be a little bit more jacked up than usual.
Oh, absolutely, Rob. You know what? Like you said, it's their last road trip before the Christmas break, so they know this is their last chance. They're going to be able to play the Bombers for a long, long time, so they know they got to come in here today and definitely put on a show and try to do the best they can to beat this number one CJHL team, so it's going to be interesting.
One spot will start things off with the group of Matt Egan. He is back in uniform. You heard Mike make reference to that. He's out there. Olofsson back in uniform tonight. That's a make left for Flint Pond. And Brock Mueller on the back end. Tanchuk has got the puck right now in Cheech Laughlin. The Bombers center in, and that's grabbed quickly here by Robertson. And the Broncos get the puck back to center. Strome will try to flip it back at Flint Pond territory. Puck does come across the Bomber line. That's grabbed by Olofsson. Fed right back to Tanchuk. Here's Egan at center. And we're going to see a tremendous pace tonight. The two best skating clubs in the league head-to-head once again. Broncos nice pass up the middle, picked up by Skogstad, already across the Bomber line. Shovels it on goal, leaves for him. We talked about him as he makes a save and hangs on. His numbers coming in tonight. What a year for Harmon Laserhulme, the 20-year-old out of Creston, B.C. 15-1-1. He's got a shutout. Goals against a 2.11, a save percentage of 926. The Broncos will counter. Aiden Fisher, who's having a pretty good year himself. 6-1, one shutout. Goals against 2.09, save percentage 939, but hasn't played the equivalent of the games yet. But a couple more, and he'll officially qualify for the top net minors of the league. Here's Carter Anderson. Anderson comes in, trying to take over right where he left off last night, that five-point performance. And I don't know if there's anybody more explosive than Anderson, the best chance of the game so far, but Fisher makes a big stop on him. The puck will come back in Flint Pond territory. That is McNutt. Can't get up. Cook knocked it down. Wired it on target. Laser Hume will grab that. And he'll make the save. A minute gone and already a pretty good chance.
Yeah, we talked about Carter Anderson's play last night. And right there, basically, the first time he touches the puck, has a great scoring opportunity. Just goes to show how dangerous he is in SJHL. And especially how dangerous he was yesterday. So hopefully we can see some more goals from him today.
Walker was good last night. He takes the faceoff here against the Broncos Lamphere. That gets back to Connor. To his shot, they score right off the hook. I think it redirected here off Lamphere out front. And the tough starts for the Bombers continue. The difference being, can Humboldt, like we say, they've had the good starts in the past. Can they build on it? Lamphere redirects it there, Austin. And just a minute into the game, it's already 1-0 Humboldt.
You know what, Rob? It's honestly, I'm not even surprised at this point. These type of goals in the beginning of games have been happening so often for the Bombers. It's just, I'm not even surprised at this point. You know what? Hopefully they'll be able to bounce back, but it's been a common theme. I don't know why it happens, but after the Bombers, they can definitely fight back here with only 8:14.
Well, that was a nice redirection. Connor Thu will get the assist. He shot it, and it redirected off Lanter. I don't think Laser Hume saw it. But a quick start for the Broncos. They're up 1-0 already. 1:08 into the opening period. And again, maybe not much of a shock, like you said, the way that starts have been going the last little while.
Yeah. If you're Scott Barney, we got the Bombers right where you want them right now.
I think for him, he wants to see if they get the next one.
I think that's the next important one.
They haven't been able to do that. Off the faceoff, the Bombers will push it out. They've had good starts here in the past. We'll see how Flintfall responds. There's Niven. He'll tap it in, try to go after it. Connor Thu, who got the assist, is leading all rookies in scoring. We'll get the puck down the ice. Luke Lepper back in uniform tonight, back for Flintfong. Good-looking 18-year-old out of Brandon. Trying to shake off his guy, throws it back in the net, gets away from Houle. Picked up and fired back to center. Waiting for it that time was the Broncos' Constantino. He's a good-looking rookie as well. There's a lot of them on this Humboldt team. They'll touch that offside. Van Vlerekamp, one of only two SJHL players going to the World Junior A Challenge. Going to be coached by Scott Barney. Van Vlerekamp and Ashton Buchberger from Nippon, the only two SJHL players to make the squad.
And also J-Rock as well for the Flint Flon Bombers. Got as the equipment manager as well.
Got himself a new haircut. Took the goatee, the mustache off. Looks like he's ready. Piccinino against Nazareth outside the Flint Flon Bomber blue line. And Flint Flon trying to answer that early goal. They'll send it in, and it's grabbed quickly from behind the net and hit the boards. And Aiden Fisher will grab that, and he'll hang on. So we'll get another faceoff inside the Humboldt zone. 1-0 Broncos on top. They're also shooting Flint Flon so far 3-1. As Piccinino had a good game last night, takes the faceoff against Nazareth. Off the draw. The Bombers will hold it in. This is Kantrick at the point. His shot blocked that time by Miller. Bouncing puck goes deep. Picked up here by Arbery. Arbery in the corner. Arbery works his way to the blue line. Let's a rip! Out front, Piccinino was there for the redirection, but it went wide. Arbery, another good-looking player for Flint Flon. Hasn't had a ton of ice time this year, but when he's been out there, he's played well. Pass to Arbery. Missed that one. It'll roll down the ice. Icing called, or is it? Yes, it is. Robertson will touch up. And we'll get a faceoff. Not a lot of flow so far here tonight, Austin.
No, it's kind of the opposite of what I was expecting. I was expecting a real fast pace, a lot of motion, but not too much so far. And just to touch on what you said about Reed Arbery, yeah, what a player he's been. Hasn't suited up in too many games, but even yesterday, touches the puck a few times. Great opportunities every time he touches the puck.
Piccinino against Court, faceoff back in the bomber zone. The left to Harmon Laser. Hume Flintfon wins the draw. Laffin will get that one over to Arbery. He'll chip it down the ice, and the veteran D-man Cook will go back to get it for Humboldt. Bounces that one ahead, tapped in that time by Newens. Flintfon gets it back. Chow back in uniform tonight. That shot went off his skate. Chow gets it right back, and he'll try to feed that up the right side to Mueller. Cook blocked it. Thought it was going to go down there for an icing call, but Cook got a piece of it. Broncos try to get the forecheck going again. The puck play broken up at center. Olsson throws that back across the Humboldt line. There's Cook ahead to Newens. Newens loses the handle, taken away that time by Olsson. Puck will come in. Here comes Egan racing after it, but the goaltender Fisher comes out, plays it to the bomber line. Puck will squirt free. McNutt there to get it. Back to Egan. He'll chip it in. It'll roll in on target. Easy save for Fisher. He'll hang on, and look out. The linesman colliding here with Spencer Hughes in behind the play. The linesman's okay, but Spencer Hughes looked like he got shaken up there a little bit.
Wow, yeah, I didn't even see what happened. Looked like he just kind of
was going. Well, I think he was, the linesman wasn't watching, and he ran right into him. Anyway, 16:49 to go in the opening period. Faceoff once again back at the Broncos zone. Anderson goes to work here with the Bomber captain, Lees. Ashton Paul who gets the puck back to Leppert. Leppert shot, easy blocker save, put to the corner that time by Fisher. Rebound picked up here by Strom, but knocked away. Leppert holds it in. Sends it over to Noah Hull. He can't keep it in. Hull's got to go back to his own blue line, and he's got to be careful. Had Mamick all over him. Leppert pushes it ahead to Ashton Paul. Ashton Paul across the line. Tried to feather that into Anderson. Anderson got in there, got a piece of it anyway. Lee's taken down hard in front of the net. Fans looking for a call there. Meanwhile, the puck will come back to the Bomber blue line where Anderson goes back to get it. Here's Anderson. Ahead to Ashton Paul. Ashton Paul at center. Gets a hold of it. Fires it back inside the Broncos zone. Anderson back of the goal. Noah Hull will pinch in. He'll grab it. Back of the goal that goes to Paul. Nobody in front of the net. Puck laying back there. Grabbed here by Noah Hull. Good work by him. Hull pinned up along the boards. Three Broncos on top of him. The puck comes back to center. Here's Tanchuk. Shovels it back in. Fisher waits for it back in his net. Plays it to the corner. Grabbed this time by Constantino. Up to center. Bouncing puck. Laughlin. Here's Silvestri. Quickly across the line. Silvestri from his off wing. A quick shot and an easy save there for Aiden Fisher. And I really noticed with Silvestri, we got a really good indication last night. He's trying to shoot the puck a lot more.
Oh, absolutely. You know what? He's been great getting assists all year as well. But you know what? He is a great shot. Probably one of the best shots on this Bomber team. And I think he's got to start utilizing it a bit more, especially from those left or right circles there. He's got a great shot from that angle.
Silvestri against Lanther, who's got the goal. Humboldt up 1-0. We're 15 and a half in the opening period. Broncos cooked down the ice. He was looking for Van Blerikom. In behind him, Van Blerikom, only 17 years old, played last year as a 16-year-old. Lanthier's got it, looking for a second of the night. He'll get it back in the goal, throws it back out front, knocked down by Miles. Miles has got it, throws it in. Puck picked up quickly by Vockler. He'll send Silvestri away to center. Right side here, this is Niven, but quickly knocked away from him, but the Bombers do keep it in. Nice job that time by Vockler to come over. Miles back of his net, had to hurry, got rid of it. Back of the net, it's Robertson. Robertson trying to spin away from traffic around the boards. It goes. Puck. Oh, nice job by Arbery to come in and knock it down and hold it in. Reed Arbery really making an impression his first couple of shifts. Piccinino knocked it down but loses the handle. Intercepted this time by Nazareth. Back to Van Blerikom at center. He'll hammer it in. Took a funny hop right on net. And leaves him taking no chances. He'll make the save and hang on. Boy, a couple of nice shifts here for young Reed Arbery.
Yeah, what a play there to keep that puck in. And I think the Bombers doing a great job right now of keeping the humble Broncos in their own zone. But I think they got to increase their zone defense a bit. That's where they struggled with yesterday, too, is they let teams hang out a bit too much in their zone, and that's where the trouble starts to happen.
Shots dead even at 4 apiece. Again, a 1-0 Humboldt lead. Lanthier the redirection for his 5th of the year. They scored 1:08 into the contest tonight. Flint Fulman giving up an early goal in several of their last few games. Weigel will knock that down. Ends up hitting Miller. And Miller was over the blue line when it hit him, so that's offside. That's why that's blown down. 14:21 to go. Busy night across the SJHL again here tonight as we take a look, of course, at all the games. I like the fact that everybody's on the same time now. And we'll update, of course, those games for you throughout the evening. We've got Melville and Battleford here tonight. We got Estevan and Kindersley, Yorkton in LaRange, and Melford in Notre Dame. So that's the action all set to go here on a Saturday. On our McDonald's out-of-town scoreboard, there are some scores coming in already. Melford a 1-0 lead on Notre Dame. And it looks like Kindersley scored on Estevan as well. So that's what's happening here so far tonight. 14:16 to go. The Bombers will make some changes. Get ready for the faceoff inside the Humboldt zone. Silvestri back out there to take the draw here against Bell. Bell had a great test series against LaRange. Had the hat-trick in the win on Thursday night. But Bond holds it in. Silvestri's quick shot saved here. Somehow Fisher through traffic. Wachler got a piece of it. That's where the big Humboldt goalie uses his size to his advantage.
And you know what? It's interesting there. You know, Coach Mike talked about Vockler and hasn't been getting as many goals as he did last year. But even on plays like that, his ability to get in front and cause traffic and for those tip possibilities, you don't always see that stuff. But great play by Vockler there.
Another faceoff between Silvestri and Skogstad. Plinfon wins the draw. Luke Leppert will pick it up. Leppert throws it out front. Goes through the blue tape and grabbed here by Mamick. Throws that in for Skogstad. They'll chase it down, try to come back out front. Grabbed it instead back of the goal that time by Mamick. Trying to throw that out front. Puck was laying at the side of the net. Mamick tied up by Hull, and this is Vockler. Puck hit a skate. Silvestri bumped off the play, but Bakker back there to grab it. Here's Jacob Bakker quickly across the Humboldt line. Gets a quick shot away. Easy save. Fisher, he'll quickly unload it. Picked up here by Weigel. Weigel to Cook. Cook a quick pass to Skogstad. He'll tip it in, and Townshik will pick it up back of the net. We're starting to get a little bit more flow to this game now. 13:20 to play in the period. Mueller tapped that across the line. Constantino took it from him. Ripped it off the glass back down the ice. Icing waved off. Bomber bench not happy about that one. Matt Egan back to center. Connor Thew cut that one off. Here's Thew across the line. Almost got stood up by Egan. Saw him at the last second. Townshik tried to get up off the boards. Loses the handle there. Spencer Mount in front. A chance. Lanthier there, and he whipped on that one. Constantino shot. Lanthier opened and he scores. It's 2-0 Humboldt. Great job that time by Constantino. He held it in, threw it out front, and Lanthier there again. No chance for the Bomber netminder. 2-0 Broncos Austin.
Yeah, and this is exactly what Scott Barney wanted, and it just kind of goes kind of what I was saying earlier, but with the Bombers in their own, when they're playing zone defense, they let too many backdoors happen. And that goal that just happened right there
was very similar to how they gave up 3 goals in last night's game.
That's exactly, Rob, that's exactly what I was going to say. Very, very similar. They just honestly leave the goalie kind of out to dry there with one side of the net wide open and let those backdoors happen. So that's where they really got to clamp down.
But a great play by Constantino to keep that in. So Lanthier's got a pair of goals. It's 2-0. The Broncos coming back looking for more. And again, Flin Flon does not want to give up multiple goals to a team of this caliber. Again, nothing against Yorkton and Melville and teams like that, but the Humboldt Broncos at a whole different level.
Yeah, you can be down 3-0 to Yorkton.
Penalty
and have
in behind the play to Aiden Chow, too. He's going to get an interference penalty.
Uh-oh.
So the Broncos a chance to bust it open here. We talked about the Flin Flon Bomber power play, how good it's been. Well, the Humboldt power play pretty good as well. They're ranked third in the league at 23%. The Bombers do have the best penalty kill. They need it to be good here.
Oh, you know what? They got the shorthanded one yesterday. Hopefully they can do it again today.
Based off inside the Flin Flon zone, Chow takes an interference penalty. And Bakker's got it. He'll set it the length of the ice. And two will go back to get it. He assisted on the first goal here tonight. And here he comes, the rookie sensation, Connor Thew to center. Drops that one back to Weigel. Weigel at center, shoveling across the Bomber line. Weagle's got it. Tried to bring it in. He'll throw it back. That picked up here by McNutt. He'll hammer that off the glass and back down the ice. Waiting for it in his own blue line. Weigel takes the pass to center. Here's Newlands. Back in Flin Flon territory. He'll backhand her in. Bakker falls down. Comes back out front. A chance ripped over top of the net that time by the captain, Newlands. Broncos hold it in. Spencer Bell along the wall. Back to Thew with the line. Thew leaves it there for Weigel. Weigel hangs on to it. Thew throws it out front. Knocked away. Silvestri. He's going to come one-on-one here against Thew to center. Sylvester with Leppert trying to jump into play. Leppert takes the pass, short-handed, ripped it over top of the net. Great opportunity there. But I'll tell you what, there wasn't a lot of room. Fisher really closed the gap there, did he not?
No, absolutely. It looked like as they were coming up, he was going to have a chance. And as they got closer and closer, really just shut the door on him just like that.
11 and a half minutes to go in the opening period. A 2-0 Humboldt Bronco lead. A pair of goals here tonight, courtesy of Patrick Lanthier. Anderson back out there for Flin Flon to take the faceoff against Hughes. There's still a 1:02 remaining in the Humboldt power play. Broncos clear to center. Cool waited for it. He'll fire it back in. Lees in there. He had a leads the league with shorthanded goals with 3. It was Piccinino who had the shorthanded goal last night. But again, it's not Yorkton they're playing here tonight. Cool goes back in there. He's pinned up back of the net. It is an icing call against the Broncos, though, so. So far, so good here on the penalty kill.
You know, honestly, Rob, even in looking at last night's game, they stopped Yorkton every single time on the penalty kill. It's almost like some days they do better on the penalty kill than they do on 5-on-5.
Lees, Anderson, Lepper, and Houle, the penalty killers here for another 44 seconds. 11:16 to go in the period. Face off here between Amirai and Lees. Lees along the wall. We'll throw it back to center. This is Noah Houle. Beats it back to Lepper. Lepper at center will get a hold of it. He'll flip it back inside the Humboldt zone. Lees races after it. High along the glass. Took a funny hop. Anderson tried to grab it, but Constantino's got it instead. Constantino gets that one up the left side. Picked up here by Amirai. He's hauled down. Luke Lepper got it back. Tried to throw it out. Big body check there. Somebody lost his glove. Lepper has got the puck now for Flin Flon at center. It's Noah Houle. He'll go back and grab it. Bombers will throw the puck inside the Humboldt zone. There's 6 seconds to go in the power play. Last opportunity. Amaral down the left wing. Quickly across the Bomber line. Kamarov, back of the net, try to set it out front. Knocked away that time by Lapp. The penalty over. There's Miles' shot, a weak one, but it still gets it to the front of the Bomber net. They'll chip it to the blue line. Constantino knocked it down. Back of the goal for Amaral. Lost a handle. Miller's got it. Miller along the boards. Poked it towards the front of the Bomber net and picked up here by Olsson. He'll start to skate away. Head manned it for Niven. Poked away from him quickly. Filler. Lanter for the hat trick. Down the wing. Lanter. Can he make another move? He tried to get too fancy there. He should have kept going. Looked like he had a good head of steam in the front of the net. He stopped. The Bombers get the puck away. Here's Robertson for the Broncos. Quickly back to Mamick. He's inside Flinfon territory. Mamick's backhander off the side of the goal. Piccinito. He'll pick it up for Flinfon. He's got it. He gets it back to center. Grabbed here by Bridger. Bridger across the Humboldt line. Shot blocked. Redirects off Miles. Goes over the glass and out of play. 9:39 to go opening period. And not a lot of offensive chances for Flinfon here so far. Media timeout. We'll take a break. The Broncos in front 2-0 here on 102.9 CFAR and FlintFonOnline.com.
Build your career with University College of the North's trades programs. Whether you're into fixing engines, crafting wood, or creating culinary masterpieces, there's more demand for skilled tradespeople in northern Manitoba than ever. With UCN, you can build your future. Visit ucn.ca. UCN, here you can.
Ayugaitu Tanao, University College of the North.
UDBay is proud to be a sponsor of this Bomber broadcast. Through bursaries, donations for hockey schools and clubs, community events, charities, and so much more, UDBay has supported the Flinfon community with their dedication and generosity for decades and continues to donate to charities, events, and organizations. UDBay thanks the people of Flinfon and the surrounding communities for their continued support.
And you're on. And welcome back to the Whitney Forum. A bit of a slow start for the Bombers here tonight. They're down 2-0, a pair of goals by Lanthier. Based off inside Humboldt territory, though. I'm not sure what's going on. Nguyen's the captain. I think he's claiming that he took a high stick and went over to the official, but nobody saw anything, so Leafs will get set for the faceoff against Skogstad inside the Humboldt zone, the left of the net, Miner Fisher. Broncos win the draw, and they'll get the puck out. Chow there. Fed that one back to McNutt. Back to Leafs at center. No room for him. That one knocked away right away. Here's McNutt. McNutt throws it back across the Humboldt line. McNutt's going to rush it in a backhander. Oh, off the shoulder there. Picked up, rebound. Leafs' shot got blocked. Miles slaps at that one. It gets past Chow. And McNutt has to go back and grab the puck inside his own zone. Fed that back to Ashton Paul. Paul up the boards. Puck is pushed back to the Humboldt blue line. That's intercepted here by Robertson. Over to Strome. Chow in there. Threw a hit at his guy. The puck will come back to Leafs. Leafs at center. Pumps it off the boards. Gets it back inside the Humboldt zone. Robertson is there. Will rim it around the boards. Took a funny hop. Came right back out front. But grabbed here by Nazareth to Nguyen's. Nguyen's across the Bomber line. Nguyen's trying to get by Leppard. Played it perfectly and blocked it. It went to the corner. Loose puck grabbed here by Hughes. He comes back to blue line. Nobody there. And it makes its way back to the Humboldt net. And Cook back there quickly to get that. Try to push that ahead to Nguyen's. He missed the pass. It should be an icing. It is. And final take it, 8:29 to go. Quick opening period here, but Humboldt defensively, not allowing a lot of Flinfon Bomber offensive zone time.
Yeah, their sticks right now are almost magnetic. They're really not letting the Bombers do anything offensively, and when the Bombers do get a shot, it's pretty far from distance.
Sylvester will take the faceoff against Nazareth. This time to the right of Aiden Fisher. The shots are 7-5 Flinfon, but I'd say only one of them have been really dangerous, and that was that chance by Carter Anderson right off the hop. Leppard, back of the goal here for Bachler. Bachler's got it. Try to shake off his guy along the boards. It's Noah Hoole. Hoole has it. Noah Hoole, little shake and bake as he stops, shoots it, save made. Silvestri out front, but again, Fisher's doing a really good job. He's just attracting pucks every which way.
Yeah, and also like you mentioned, great job to the Humboldt defense, really making the Bombers play from the outside right now, which is Bombers really don't do too often. They're very up close and personal, and they use a lot of cross-crease passes and one-timers, but right now, really letting it rip from the point.
Lanthier against Silvestri back inside the Humboldt zone. 8:13 to go in the opening period. A 2-0 Humboldt lead. Silvestri looks like it's going to get waved out of the faceoff circle, so they can't decide who's going to take it. Bachler's going to go in and take it against Lanthier. The story of the opening period offensively. Two goals for him. off the faceoff. Who gets that one through, kicked away. Stick save made by Fisher. When Fontana jump on the rebound, Silvestri in the corner. This is Bachler. Back of net for Niven. Niven pinned up, but Bachler there to grab it. Bachler really looking good the last couple of hockey games. He gets a shot from a sharp angle there. Silvestri will pick it up back of that. Silvestri, a wraparound attempt. Gets a couple of whacks at it. Fisher stopped him not once, but twice. Lepper falls down. He holds it in somehow. And they'll try to get it back out front. They do. Niven back up front to Hooley. Scores! Noah Hool celebrating in front of the Humboldt bench. That could be dangerous. But that'll be Riley Niven's first point as a Bomber. He gets it back to blue line there, Austin. Enough of that. And he'll get it through traffic on target. And Noah Hool, who's had a fantastic season, able to convert, and that's one of the few shots that I don't know if Fisher saw completely cleanly. A lot of traffic in front.
And I think we got to mention, you know what, that goal doesn't happen without that huge play there by Luke Lepper.
Yeah, no kidding.
To keep that puck in, what a great play that was. And that was it's probably a second great play of the game. That other one, when Nuance had that breakaway, did a great job with the stick to keep it out. So great job by Luke Lepper there to get that goal started.
So Niven should get an assist, which will be his first play to the Bomber this year, as he was able to throw it to him back at the blue line. We'll see if they get Lepper a second assist. Bachler. They don't give Niven the assist. He should have got one. They missed that. Nothing against Bachler, but I don't think he had an assist on that one. That was Niven that fed it to him back at the blue line. Seems to happen quite a bit, missing assists. Anyway, the Bombers will take it. Olofsson's got it. Back to the point. This is Chow. Back on a one-timer off the glove that time. McNutt got a good ripper, and Fisher stopped him. Broncos back the other way. The flip one on the board. Here's Miller across the line. They're offside. And they'll blow that down at 6:51. So 12 shot on the period for Flintblom. And a nice goal from Noah Hool, his sixth of the year.
Finally looking like the Bombers are starting to pick it up. And you know what? We mentioned the Bombers always have these rough starts and how they always kind of make a few mistakes here and there. But I think the thing we forgot to mention was how many offensive powers they have who have the ability to score, which is makes it okay to sometimes make those mistakes and go down a bit.
Lanthier, Piccinito face off outside the Bomber blue line. Flintblom on the board. Noah Hool has got a goal. Here's McNutt to center. He can move. What a move that was. McNutt, oh, off the crossbar. Now the puck is laying on top of the net. McNutt shaking big. Able to go right up the middle. Beat both defensemen. Beat Fisher, but he couldn't beat the red bar.
Oh, Rob, if that would have went in, that
would have sensational.
That would have been goal of the year. And I'm surprised. You know what? I think I've only seen him do that a couple times this season. I don't know why he doesn't pull those kind of moves out more often.
Boy, he really made a nice rush there. McNutt's been a real nice addition since they got him from LaRange in that big blockbuster trade earlier in the season. Here's a chance now. Bridger a chance. He ripped that one wide. Piccinito, he's after it in the corner. Piccinito trying to get away here from Skogstad. Good pursuit. Throws it out front. There's a chance by Bridger. Stick save made. Puck laid underneath Fisher. And boy, Flintblom starting to get a lot of shots through. That goal seems to have kind of woken them up here late in the opening period.
Yeah, and it looks like Fisher and even the defense of the Humboldt Broncos here is starting to get a little bit loose. And, you know, they're making a bit more mistakes than probably they'd like. And as we've kind of seen so far throughout this entire year, Rob, is the second half of the first period is where the Bombers actually start to turn things on a little bit.
Here we go. The line of Lees, Hall, and Anderson. Lepper been great tonight on the back end with Noah Hool. And as Lees will line up for the faceoff against Nazareth, they've been facing off against each other a lot tonight. Lees, the best Bomber faceoff man, so I'm assuming that Nazareth is too, with Scott Barney wanting to get him out there. He's lined up against Lees for pretty much every draw here tonight in this game. Flintblom will flip the puck to Lees at center. It'll give and go to Anderson. He poked that one in. Paul's in there. He knocked it down midair. Back out front! And Anderson almost redirected that one, and Astrid Paul threw it to the front of the net, and Anderson got a stick on that one. Bombers hold it in. There's Miles. He'll fire that around the boards. Picked up here quickly by Hughes. The drop past the center ice. Grabbed here by Robertson. Feeds it back to Nuance. Inside Flintblom territory. Drop that one back there for Hughes. He spins. Puck held in here by Weigel. Lifts it along the boards that time. Picked up back to the net by Nazareth. Knocked away from him. Here's Ashton Paul. Inside his own zone. Paul trying to flip it ahead. Nazareth got a piece, but now he goes down. Bombers get three guys away to center. Paul tipped it in. Weigel there, knocked it away from him. Lees tried to keep it in, but a second too late. Here's Nuance. Back inside Flintblom territory. To Court cutting to the front of the net. He's pinned up. Puck comes back the other way to Niven at center. Niven tried to get free. Cook. Niven took care of him. Here's a chance now for Anderson. back of the net. Trying to throw that out front to Vaclav. Weigel and Anderson tie up. Puck picked up by Court. Over to Miller through his legs. Tanchuk plays it ahead, or does he? Nope, knocked down by Court. Court a chance off the glove that time of Leiser Hume. Good action again. Niven will poke it back to center. Amaral saw that, knocked it down. Gets it back to Court. To the slot! Missed by much. Had Harmon Leiser Hume guessing along the right side. Broncos hold it in. There's Laughlin. Back to Niven. That'll hit the official, but picked up here by Vaclav. Vaclav away to center. Across the line. Dropped it back to Silvestri. Alexei Silvestri. A backhander on target. Save made. Fisher got his pad down, and he'll grab that with a conference in front of the Humboldt net. Down to 4:26 to go in the period. You know, it's funny. Shots 15-5 Flintstone, but that's not really indicative of this period, is it?
No, absolutely not at all. And you know, Bombers, we're used to seeing them outshoot teams, but you know, it's kind of been a common theme as well. They get lots of shots, even those games against Melville that they ended up losing. They're outshooting Melville by 15-20 shots, and you know, they still end up losing. So get lots of good shots, but it doesn't mean they're all great.
Mueller, Olofsson, and Egan, the forward group here for Flintstone. Chow and McNutt on the back end. McNutt just missing from tying up the game by an inch the last time he was out there as he rattled that one off the crossbar. Nice job by Chow to knock it down. Trying to slide that pass to Olofsson. Intercepted by Lampier, and he'll flip the puck back to Marmer blue line. Here's Van Blerikon. Very dangerous. McNutt, though, stayed with him. Knocked it away from along the wall. Spencer Bell in there. Tied up. Puck to blue line. Knocked down. Fired on target that time. A good low shot courtesy of Robertson. And Leiser Hume had to be careful on that one. No rebound. He'll make the save and hang on. 4:03 to go in the period. Shots once again 16-8 now in favor of Flintstone. And the Broncos have a little bit of a conference here deciding what they want to do for this faceoff. That's going to be inside the Flintstone zone, the right of Harmon Leiser Hume. Pichito will take the draw against Lampier. 4:03 remaining in the opening frame. Off the faceoff. This is Leppert. Inside his own zone. Up the boards, picked up this time. Here comes Bridger. Right side for Noah Hull. Flintstone offside. Arbery a little bit extra anxious. Had to get outside the zone. Flintstone will fire it in. Robertson is there. He'll play it out. Look out. Hull got crossed up. It's an odd man rush. Van Blerikom's got it. Can't get around Leppert, though. Made another tremendous defensive play. Broncos hold it in. There's Spencer Bell. He's hit hard, but able to keep the puck anyway. Throws it back out the blue line. Robertson knocked it down. That shot got blocked here by Arbery. Here's Pichonito. Arbery along the boards, can't clear. Bell will hold it in. Feeds it back to Van Blerikom. His shot. Oh, dribbled through, but a good right pad save made nonetheless. And Flintstone having a tough time getting the puck out. They will lift it down the ice this time. Miles races back to get it. Had Pichonito on him. Stretch pass too far. Icing called against the Broncos. 3:08 to go in the opening period.
How impressive has Luke Leppert and Reed Arbery been so far this game? You know what? Not making huge plays, but making the small ones that make a huge difference. Unbelievable to see these guys, what they're doing tonight.
Here comes the big line of Paul, Leeds, and Anderson. They've been held off the sheet so far. Dustin Leeds, like we said, leading the league in goals. He had another goal last night for his league leading, 22nd of the year. Gets it back here to Chow. He'll rim that around the boards here. It wasn't really much. Very much openings and only really option that he had. Anderson back of the net. Tries to get free. Back of the goal to Ashton Paul. Paul, nice drop pass in the corner for Anderson. Back to the point. Held in by McNutt. Bouncing puck picked up by Robertson. He'll lift it ahead to Van Blerikom at center. Dropped it back to Mamick. Mamick a chance. A good quick shot off the glove again of Harmon Leiser Hume. Here's McNutt. He'll pick up the loose puck. He'll fire it down the ice and hit Van Blerikom as he's going off the ice, and Paul will take it from him. Ashton Paul towards the front of the net. Stick save made here by Fisher. Bombers try to jump on that loose puck. Back of the net. It's Weigel, though. Bounce it off the board. Cut off by Tanchuk. Throws it back to Paul. Paul, nice job to knock it down. Then it gets away from him. Here's Anderson. He'll fire it right back in. Lees tries to get in there. Two or three guys on top of him. Puck rolls the blue line. Laughlin a shot. Blocked by Weigel. Picked up here by the Broncos. Strongo takes a big hit. Got that one back to Skogstad. He sends it on target. Bouncing puck. Leiser Hume got rid of it quickly. Tanchuk back to his net. Under 2 minutes to go. Here's Carter Anderson at his blue line. Carter Anderson up the right side. Niven. He'll pick it up. A quick chance from an off angle. Weak shot, but he did hit the target. Save is made by Fisher, and the Bombers will get a faceoff inside the Humboldt zone 1:46 to go, first period, 2-1 Broncos in front.
And it looks like we're finally starting to see that pace that we were expecting to see at the beginning of the game. Both teams moving real fast right now and looking to get that next goal, because the next one is going to be huge, Rob, for sure.
Nazareth again set for the faceoff against Jacob Bachler, and somebody move quickly. I think Nazareth is going to get waved out this time, so Nuens goes in to take it. Faceoff to the left of Aiden Fisher here tonight. You almost get the sense that both Jacob Bachler and Ashton Paul are ready to break out at some point, don't you?
Well, oh, absolutely.
Quick chance. Niven lost his helmet. He was going to skate off the ice, but there's a whistle, so he won't have to. But I'm just getting that sense that Ashton Paul, Jacob Bachler, just all of a sudden is going to break out here.
Well, you can even see it in the play right
there. Penalty coming up here, actually, to the Broncos. Not to cut you off there, Austin. I think Spencer Hughes took a hit there, and that's what knocked Niven's helmet off. So Blinkwan going to get a late power play. Go ahead, you're going to say.
Wow, this is going to be huge for them. But you know what? It almost seems like every time they touch the puck, they're about a foot or two away from having a huge play. And I think you're right. You know what? You can see it in their eyes. You can see it when they're on the ice. They're about one or two strides away from making a big play. And I think we're just waiting for it to happen, Rob. I 100% agree.
The Bombers, a couple power play goals last night. They'll get a chance again tonight. The league's best power play at 27%. The Humboldt Broncos, the second best penalty kill at 85. And what's going on here? They can't decide who's going to be on the ice here for Humboldt. As Miles went out there, they're calling him off. And I think they got that straightened out. And Sylvester will take the faceoff against Skogstad. Late power play here for Flintbond. Broncos win the draw. And Robertson will set it down the ice. So Hughes gets the penalty for a high stick. And here comes the Bomber power play. Chance to tie the game. Bachler, seven power play goals to lead the way this year. Gets it in deep to Leaves, but loses the handle right away. Intercepted by Skogstad. The length of the ice, he'll get it down there. And Laser Hill will make the save. Noel Hull, who's got the Bomber goal there to collect the loose puck. Swings the pass, flip to the center. Here comes Leaves. Leaves, oh, nice pass outside here to Anderson. Back to blue line. Hull races over to keep it in. Across the ice it goes here to Bachler. Bachler along the left wall, side of the goal that time. Leaves was open, but he couldn't handle it cleanly. Showing it back to Bachler. Bachler, back of the corner for Leaves. Back out front to Anderson. Missed the pass. He's thinking shot, I think, before it gets there. Hull back at center. So we got a minute remaining in the period. Bachler in for Leaves. He'll knock it down. Throws it out front. Past everybody. Knocked down by Bachler. He'll hold it in. Throws it back out front. Nobody there. This is Silvestri back of the net. Back out front to Bachler. Bachler tried to come out front. That hit a leg. Back to Noah Hull again. His shot. Oh, bounce. It just missed again. Fisher had no idea where it was going. Knocked down here by Anderson. Hull along the wall. 26 seconds to go. Throws it back out front to Anderson. This is Bachler. Side of the net again. Picked up by Leaves. They're going to have to get a shot away here sooner than later. 18 seconds remaining. Bachler can't hold it in. Hull goes back to center. He'll drop it back to Bachler. 11 seconds to go. Bachler quickly down the wing. Bachler cutting in a backhander, and he missed it and then takes a big tumble. Held in by Hull. 3 seconds remaining. Shot. Deflects it. Fucked by Silvestri. Can't tap it in. Robertson. He'll grab a hold of it. And the Bombers come really close to tying the game. But just can't get it to go. And they'll get 18 seconds of carryover power play time for the second period. Move the puck around really well. But give Humboldt credit. Did a really good job keeping everybody to the outside.
Oh, you know what? They've been doing that for most of this game so far. All first period. Most of the Bombers' shots, even the goal, right, have been from pretty far outside, but still Bombers getting great opportunities there. And we talk about how dangerous Jacob Bachler can be. Huge score last season, hasn't had as many goals as expected this year, but you can see even right there on that opportunity he had. Great speed, great cuts, and like we said, it's like you can feel he's about to have a breakout game.
We'll take a break. The first intermission show for the North of 53 Co-op is coming up. Broncos lead the Bombers 2-1. That's a story so far after one here on 102.9 CFAR and FlintFlonOnline.com.
For a limited time, Claire. McDonald's, enjoy a tasty breakfast trio.
Your six.
Sausage, bacon, or chicken McMuffin, a hash brown, and a small premium roast coffee for only $5 plus tax. Available before 11 a.m. at participating McDonald's restaurants in Canada. Plus, earn points on every order with the My McDonald's Rewards exclusively on the McDonald's app. Redeem points for your McDonald's favorites like McFlurries, McChickens, and more. Download the app today.
Life is full of big decisions, but one people often forget is purchasing new windows and doors. And at Jim's Custom Doors and Windows, they help you make the right decision with Huron Windows and Doors. From style and material to purpose and design, they'll show you what's best for your home. And with Huron's Energy Star certified products, not only will you stay protected, but save money as well. Make your next big decision with Huron Windows and Doors at Jim's Custom Doors and Windows.
Finding that just right present for everyone on your list can be challenging. So rather than go online or just guess what they want, visit the North of 53 Co-op. An already wrapped charcuterie or cheese box filled with artisan items is perfect for the person who already has everything. And for those on your list with a sweet tooth, tis the season for fruitcake, gingerbread house kits, and
10 seconds.
Don't worry about things being the wrong size or color, because at the North of 53 Co-op, you're at home there.
Clear.
Alrighty, welcome back to the first intermission for the North of 53 Co-op. Austin Mattis is with us here tonight, Austin, and let's recap that first period scoring. Some of you talked, maybe it was the kiss of death. I don't know, you mentioned it. Not to kind of give up that early goal. Well, that happened a minute eight in. Lanthier, it was a nice goal, though. I mean, he just basically went to the front of that, redirected the Connor through shot, and that's how you're going to beat a good goalie like Harbin Laser Hume. You got to redirect pucks past him, and a good start for the Broncos there tonight.
When, if you look at yesterday, it was very similar goal to some of the ones they got yesterday, right? It's just the Bombers playing zone defense. They play good for about 30 seconds, and after that, they find themselves a little flat-footed, and they leave the backdoor opportunities way too open.
That would have been the second goal you're talking about.
Yes.
So Lanthier gets the first one in the redirection of the shot from through at the blue line. Then he gets wide open like him. Constantino, though, he made a heck of a play to knock it down along the wall. And I think Flint Flon thought they were going to get the puck out. They didn't. So you got to react. When the guy knocks the puck down, and I think they were caught a little bit flat-footed. And, you know, Lanthier went to the good spot. Nobody in front of the net. And Laser Hume was cheating to the other side. So he has a wide open net. And he buries it. Second of the night, sixth of the year. That came at the 6-11 mark. But the good news for Flint Flon, and we saw that a lot the last few games, when they've had the slow starts, they've been able to respond and answer. They did. A big goal by Noah Hull here tonight. They gave Bachler and Leppard the assist. It should be Niven, as he was the one that fed it back to him. But nonetheless, a quick shot. And, you know, I think the reason why that one finds the back of that is because I don't think Fisher saw that one. He sees him. He stops him. He's been like a magnet, like you said, been able to follow the puck all over the place. The one time he didn't, go figure, goes in the net.
Well, absolutely. You know what? Like I said, the Bombers have 18 shots on goal right now, and he's basically seen every single one. And like you said, the one he didn't see didn't go in. So I think the Bombers got to do a bit better of a job kind of creating that traffic in the net. But also to touch on that goal is not happening without that huge play by Luke Leppard at the blue line. He basically jumped up in the air, a dive for it to keep it in. I don't even know how he kept it in. But
well,
it was,
he was fortunate. He went down, and I was waiting for it to come out, but he did keep it in. So good effort. But he's had a good game tonight.
Yeah, it was unbelievable efforts, and also by guys like Reed Arbery, just lots of effort plays from everyone on the Bombers and the Humboldt Broncos. So it may be 2-1, but I think it's going to be a whole lot closer. Obviously, only down one, but I'm expecting the Bombers to get a goal back here, and we're going to have a very intense hockey game.
So Lanthier, a pair of goals, is 5th and 6th for the Broncos. Hools come back with a 6 for Flint Flon. Shots 18-11 for the Bombers. Humboldt 0 for 1. Flint Flon has 18 seconds remaining in their first power play chance. It'll carry over to the second period. Flint Flon, when they trail after one, doesn't happen very often this year. Their record is sitting at 3-1, so they've been able to respond after being trailing after one. But Humboldt leads after one this year. Their record 12-0-2-1. We'll see what happens here for the second. More of the first intermission coming up. Adam McNutt will be our Northland Ford Flint Flon Bomber player profile. He joins us next right here on 102.9 CFER and FlintFlonOnline.com.
Attention.
On now at Trent Appliance Center, it's the Whirlpool Black Friday sales event. Create the perfect home you want with appliances that fit what you need. It's the more you buy, the more you save Black Friday sales event. Buy one, save $100. Buy two, save $250. Buy three, save $550. Because the more you buy, the more you save. Now's the time to take advantage of buying Whirlpool appliances. Shop Crate and Furniture in Whirlpool and save.
Northland Ford proudly supports the Flint Flon Bombers throughout the SJHL season. We know that the Bombers will play tough like the Ford F-150, the toughest truck on the market for over 40 years. Northland Ford helping the community cheer on the Bombers as they work to bring a championship to the best fans in the league.
10 seconds.
Provide you with the best selection on their lot. In the North, for the North, Northland Ford, the dealership you tell your friends about.
You're on.
Welcome to our first intermission on Northland Ford Flint Flon Bomber player profile. Adam McNutt will join us here. Adam, been a nice addition here to the Flint Flon Bombers. Of course, lots of experience in the Western Hockey League. Tell me how it all kind of worked out for you, how you became a Bomber. How did that all kind of unfold?
Yeah, you know, I started this year with the Swift Current Broncos. I went out for camp, had a bit of an injury up there, so I didn't get to play too many preseason games. Got a regular season game in at the start of the year, and then I got put on waivers, cleared waivers. Had a few options, but, you know, Flint Flon's where I wanted to be, so I came here, and it's been great ever since.
How long was Flint Flon kind of on your radar screen?
You know, since the day that I found out, you know, I talked with my agent, you know, he said it's a great place, it's a winning organization, great organization in general, so, you know, I was kind of when it came on my radar, and I played against them a few times, always been a good place to play, and always a hard game, so.
That's right, because you were with LaRange, that's how the big trade came, so I guess you must have informed the Wolves that, in fact, you didn't want to go back there?
Yeah, you know, I just wanted to take more of a run at it this year, and, you know, I thought Flint Flon would be the place for that.
When you're playing against the Bombers with LaRange, did you ever think that one day you'd be on this team?
No, you know, it never really crossed my mind, but it's kind of crazy how it works out.
Boy, what a year you guys are having, too. Only one regulation loss. Like you said, I mean, I think you knew the team would be competitive, but has it gone beyond expectation for you, the team record right now?
Yeah, you know, anytime you can get 20 wins before December even, it's pretty crazy. So, you know, obviously you expect to lose some games here and there, but just the way that we work and the way we practice, I'm not surprised that we've been winning this much.
What have been the keys for success for this team?
Just playing together, I think, you know, every time we play our game and use Rager and Kager systems, you know, we dominate games, and it's unreal to see. So just doing our jobs, buying in, and playing the right way.
Now, I'm not exactly sure what role you had in the Western Hockey League, but I'm assuming you probably get a little bit more offensive freedom here?
Yeah, for sure. You know, I get some power play time here and get to try to work on my game that way, which is really nice. I play a bit more of a defensive game in the Western and a couple fights, etc. But, yeah, a hard game. You know, I like to bring that over here and get some power play time for sure, which is nice.
Speed of the game. Is there a big difference between the Western League and this level?
You know, with the size of some of the rinks that we play in, it kind of evens it out. You know, with the smaller rink, fast skaters, it evens out. But I would say sometimes it's a bit slower. But other than that, you know, it's up there with the Western for sure.
Well, and you played some games in the SPHL too, so I guess you kind of knew what it was all about anyway.
Yeah, for sure, yeah. But, yeah.
Don't want to get too far ahead of ourselves, but the LaRange Ice Wolves, you go there Wednesday, then a home and home, of course, just before Christmas. Your thoughts on those games? Are those kind of games you looked at right away when the trade was made?
Well, you know, I don't really like to look too far ahead in the schedule, you know, just take it one game at a time, but I'll be excited to go up there and play the Mal again. It'll be fun. Hopefully we get to 4 points.
It'll feel different for you going there as a visitor, do you think?
I didn't play too many games there, but maybe a bit different for sure, be on the other side of the rink, but it should be good.
You know, a big win again last night. Last few games, the team's kind of started slowing games. Can you kind of put your finger on that?
Yeah, I'm not too sure. I think on the road we had some hard starts, which, you know, we've been trying to nip in the bud a bit here. But, you know, anytime they get off to a bad start, it's imperative to have a good second period. And we've been getting on that, which is really good to see. So hopefully we can just bring it right off the start this game tonight.
Well, like your coach has said as well, when you're the number one team in the country or the number one team in the league, everybody wants to beat you. Have you noticed that the teams that maybe the second time you play them a little bit different than it was the first time?
Yeah, you know, like you said, when you're first, everybody's going to have their best game against you. So, you know, you can kind of notice guys start to keen in on key players on our team and shutting down some plays that we like to run. But other than that, you know, I think we execute still when they do try and slow us down. But, yeah, I think just stick to our game and we'll still win it.
Are you pretty happy with your game personally, how you've been able to gel with this team?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I mean, there's been some areas in the last few games I've been getting scored on, I'm not too happy about. But other than that, yeah, I've been really excited and happy with the way I've gelled with the team, and they've really supported me well, so it's awesome.
Well, you seem to like to grab the puck and skate with it, which is natural for this team with the guys like Lees, Anderson, I mean, Bach. There's a lot of guys that can move. It seems like it kind of fits your forte. Is that another reason kind of why you didn't maybe want to go back to LaRange, maybe because this team is more to your style?
Yeah, you know, I just like I said before, I thought this would be a great place to win, and I think Rags told me I could play my game how I wanted to when we talked, and it was, well, through my agent, and it was nice to hear. So coming here and getting to do that's nice, and it's good to see Justin and Carter and Bachler, everyone having success they are this year. You know, it's really awesome for them.
You played hockey in a lot of different places for a long time. What is it? Talk about the fans in the Whitney Forum. How special has that been?
Yeah, you know, I played a lot of sold out, well, not sold out, but lots of fans and stadiums, and Whitney is one of the loudest places I've played. It's awesome. You can feel the energy on the bench from a chipped out puck. It's pretty crazy. It's a special place to play for sure.
And I don't wait till playoffs. It's going to be a whole new ball game again. Quickly before I let you go, biggest hockey moment for you anywhere that you played that jumps out so far in your hockey career, something that really jumps out at you for you personally?
My biggest hockey moment? Well, it'd probably just be my first Western League goal. You know, I didn't really get too many playoff experiences up there, but that would probably be one of the biggest ones so far, yeah.
What would be your biggest moment for the Bombers so far?
I don't know, maybe our 20th win before December. That was pretty exciting to be a part of. So.
What about your first goal in this league? Tell me about it.
Yeah, it was a good one. I was coming down on a penalty kill in the wet here and opened up looking for a pass on a 2-on-1, took the shot and got lucky and she went in and, yeah.
That always feels good, doesn't it?
Oh, for sure it does, yeah.
And I have to ask you, too, before I let you go, your favorite team and your favorite player growing up?
The Boston Bruins, and my favorite player is Zdeno Chara.
That's a pretty good one to emulate yourself after. Listen, Adam, thanks a lot for doing this. Good luck against the good Humboldt Bronco team tonight. Should be a lot of fun, and good luck the rest of the way.
Awesome. Thank you very much.
Adam McNutt, a Northland Ford Flint Flon Bomber player profile here on 102.9 CFAR and FlintFlonOnline.com.
Clear. Gosh darn it, we're in last place. We need someone who wants to go fast.
I want to go fast.
We'll get in there, Ricky Bobby, but first take this Jack's Links beef jerky.
Woohoo! This is one of the best damn experiences of my entire life.
And Ricky Bobby takes first place in the Jack's Links 500.
Arctic beverages and Jack's Links beef jerky. Feed your wild side.
The holiday season is made for fellowship, tidings of joy, and goodwill towards all.
And the reindeer races. Nothing says Christmas like getting free stuff. When you hear the jingle bells, that's your cue to call. Pick the winning local rider and reindeer, and you win. Doesn't matter if you're naughty or nice, to be part of the contest that is great for greatness' sake. Brought to you in part by Dambo's Kitkat, Creighton's Pizza, Urban Trends, Baba's Bulk Bin, Pets Threads, and
10 seconds.
CFAR, your radio. Ho, 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 ho.
You're on.
And welcome back to Whitney Farm. The Humboldt Broncos have made their way back on the ice. That means the football bomber probably not too very far behind. Let's see what's happening with McDonald's out-of-town scoreboard here tonight. We mentioned, of course, plenty of other games in the SPHL. We got Battleford leading Melville. That's 2-0 right now after the opening period. And what else do we have here tonight? Kendersley leads Estevan 2-1. That's after one. LaRange, a 2-0 lead on Yorkton after one period of play here tonight. And Melfort now has taken a 3-1 lead on Notre Dame. That's also after one period of play. Manitoba Junior Hockey League action tonight. Selkirk, a 3-1 lead on Swan Valley in the second period. Dauphin-Steinbeck even at one in the second. It's Weiwei leading Portage 1-0 after one. The Freeze and Ipua 2-2 after one. A couple NHL finals for today. The Jets a nice win as they knock off Connor Bedard and the Blackhawks 3-1. Dallas all over Tampa Bay 8-1. Ouch. Rangers beat Nashville 4-3. The Islanders over Florida 4-3. Carolina a 5-1 lead on Buffalo in the third. Detroit leads Montreal 4-2 after two. Philly leads Pittsburgh 3-2 in the third. Ottawa 2-0 lead on Seattle in the third period. All even between Boston and Toronto 2-2 in the third. And later tonight, Colorado at Anaheim. We've got Vancouver at Calgary and Washington at Vegas. And I should remind people, if you have some time tomorrow, pop by both the Sportex and Whitney Forum, the big Mel Pearson Novice Hockey Tournament taking place here in town.
Oh, wow.
We're underway in the second period, a 2-1 Humboldt lead. Bombers on the power play. They almost got Anderson free and behind the D. Anderson will pick it up, back the blue line to Hull. He'll hold it in. Here's Anderson, a quick chance. That one got blocked by Robertson. It came right back to Anderson. Tries to hold it in, he does, out front to Leppert. Leppert, back out front, Paul can't pull the trigger. Knocked down in front, Hull's got it. Anderson, back to five with side, out front to Paul, can't get his stick free, they jab away, and it just goes wide. Noah Hull holds it in at the right point, his shot ricochets wide, side of the net. Anderson after it, he'll knock it down, good pressure here by Flintbon, finally taken away by Hughes. He'll lift it out, and Hull's got to race back and get it, throws it to center. Hughes got it back, but Paul took it from him. Noah Hull inside his own zone, trying to get back on track. Flintflon comes up empty on the power play. They're 0-1 in the game. Here's Newens at center. Back across the bomber line, knocked away here by Paul. Paul to center. Ashton Paul dropped that one back to Anderson. Anderson from the off wing and off the side of the net, and that'll hit the glass and go over the netting, and boy, can he shoot a puck.
Some great opportunities there by Flynn Fawn. Great opportunities and great cuts by Noah Hull going crashing the net there to get those openings. But Fisher doing a great job of being able to see everything. And I think there was a few bobbles on the sticks there by the Bombers, but still Fisher looking red hot right now.
Walker to take the faceoff here against Court. To the left of the Humboldt netminder, Aiden Fisher. Humboldt in front 2-1, just underway in the second period. Chichu Laughlin gets that back to center, but Court there to take it from him. Humboldt offside. Now Nuance will grab it. He's across the line. Gets a good shot away over top of the Bomber net. Picked up by Silvestri. Back to Niven. Tried to get set, but he couldn't pick it up. Bachler does. He's across the line. Back out front to Niven. Niven will pick it up along the boards. Throws it in the corner this time for Silvestri. Silvestri tried to work his way out front. Looked like he was going to get there, but Weigel knocked away at the last second. Back out front to Patrick. A shot on target. Fisher the same. Rebound. Oh, Niven. Or make that Bachler haul down. He's going to draw a penalty. And Jacob Walker, like I said, he's had a little extra bounce in his step these last couple of hockey games.
Yeah, every time he touches the puck, Rob, it just seems, like I said, he's about one or two steps away or strides away from scoring a goal. And right there, if he doesn't get tripped up there, that's possibly a goal. As you saw, that one side on the wraparound was wide open.
So Flint Flon right back on the power play. 18:15 to go, second period. The Bombers doubling the Broncos in shots, 21-11, but they're down 2-1. Can they tie it up here? Lees takes Miles to the ice. Puck underneath him. He'll grab that and they'll blow that down with a whistle. So Justin Lees had a kind of a bit of a tough time going tonight, and I know why that is. The Broncos have had a couple guys on him this entire game.
Well, you know what? They know how dangerous he is. He's not the leading scorer in the league for no reason. And you know what? The Humboldt Broncos doing a great job. Honestly, really haven't noticed him doing too much today, so it must be working.
Skogstad wins the faceoff. Broncos get it down the ice on target. Leeserhulme will make the save, and Noah Hull, who once again has the Bomber goal tonight, goes back to get it in his own end. Swings the pass to Walker, quickly to Anderson across the ice. Anderson around Robertson, trying to come back out front, but broken up here by Cook, the other Humboldt D-man. Lindblom holds it in, it gets away from Walker. Short-handed breakaway here from Mamick. Mamick in alone. Mamick a shot, and stood up that time by Leeserhulme, came out and cut down the angle. Here comes Anderson back the other way, feeds it back way offside. Silvestri took the pass, but Walker was a couple strides ahead of him on the far wing there.
Leeserhulme, great job on that save, and we've kind of talked about it all year, Rob. Whenever Leeserhulme needs to step up and make some plays, he always does. A prime example right there. 1-0 there for the Humboldt Broncos, and the great save to step out of the net and close up the angle.
17:34 to go in the second period. Flint Flon on the power play for another minute 19. Piccinito getting set for the faceoff here. As he lines up, Bombers win the draw. They get it in quickly. Paul, nice pass to Piccinito. Can't shoot it though, knocked away. Tanchuk holds it in. Let's see, rep out front. That got blocked, came back to McNutt. McNutt slides it through to Piccinito along the left-hand boards. This is Piccinito, a little bit of room, trying to cut to the front, poked away that time by Fisher. And then the loose puck grabbed here and set down the ice by Strom. Racing back to get it is Bridger. 48 seconds to go in the Flint Flon power play. Just under 17 to go in the hockey game, or in the second period. Bridger off the boards, hammered it in. Ashton Paul waits for it. Back of the goal for Bridger. Try to come back to Piccinito too far. Grabbed here by McNutt. He'll throw it back in deep, but throws it right on the stick that time of Constantino. Constantino plays that one ahead to center. Picked up by Spencer Bell. He'll flip it in, and this power play hasn't really been able to set up. Here's Tanchuk. Here's the pass once again to McNutt. Off the left side, Piccinito across the line quickly. Throws it back to Bridger. Hit a stick, didn't get it cleanly. McNutt knocked it down. Tried to feed that one in deep for Piccinito too far. Ashton Paul along the boards. Tries to hold it up, but picked up and set down the ice by Amaral. 2 seconds to go in the power play, and that one, not a lot of chances at all. I think just a one shot. Here's Mueller. He's across the line. His shot goes wide. Grabbed quickly and picked up off the backboards at the side of the net this time for the Humboldt goaltender, Aiden Fisher. But boy, great penalty kill there by the Broncos.
Yes, a second good one today. And you know what? Not only have they killed it, they really limit the shots there for the Bombers on both of them so far. So doing a great job. And Flint Flon Bombers have the best power play in the league. So great job on them.
Olofsson will take the face off against Lanthier, who's got both Humboldt goals tonight. 16:08 to go, second period, 2-1 Humboldt in front. You know, a lot of guys get later in the faceoff circle. Olofsson's out, so Mueller goes in. Broncos grab it, Weigel quickly around the board to Van Blerikom, chipped it just outside the line. Mueller will get it, he'll hammer it right back in. Weigel waited for it. The big Humboldt D-man, Egan, pinned him up, and they get the turnover. Here's Noah Hull. His shot off the stick out of play. And Noah Hull always seems to step up against the good clubs.
You know what? He's been great all of this season. Not even offensively, defensively, but one of the things I love about him is his ability to keep the puck in the zone. That's what I noticed so much from him. 90% of the time, if the puck's coming his way, going to go back in a neutral zone, he always keeps it in.
Bombers try to jump on this one. They do. Here's Lepper with a chance. Lepper up the wall, a shot. Good left pad saved that time by Fisher. Oh, Lepper kept the puck in, and he will knock this one away. It's another turnover outside the Bronco blue line. Noah Hull gets it in tight. Tried to feed that one back to Olsen, but now it's the Broncos with a chance. Lanthier down the wing for the hat trick, and he just missed it wide. He had Van Blerikom in there. Puck chipped the blue line, racing over to keep it in as Weigel. Van Blerikom whiffs at that one. Puck picked up by Olsen. He'll get it back to Mueller at center. Mueller will dump it in. Football will make changes, but Mueller is going to come out and play it, but he won't get a chance because Fisher beat him to the punch, and he came out and played it himself. Van Blerikom looking for the pass from behind the D, but he can't pick it up. Here's Chow. Moves it ahead to Bakker. Jacob Bakker across the line, a shot on target again. And reaching down and grabbing that, Aiden Fisher. So lots of shots for Flin Flon as they continue to outshoot the Broncos 24-13, but down the goal. And like you mentioned earlier, which was a great observation on your point, one thing to have a lot of shots, but where are the quality chances coming from?
And Humboldt's really made them play from the outside a lot today, not something they're really used to.
Bakker set for the faceoff here. Against Nazareth, once again back in Humboldt territory. Sylvester gets a chance, but that got blocked. Here's Chow for the blue line. His shot knocked down in front. Scooped up here by Thu. Thu to center. Dished that one off quickly to Miller. Dropped it back. Ooh, it's a chance, and he ripped that into the glove. And a big save made once again here by the Bomber netminder, Harmon Laser-Hume. 14:46 to go, second period. And Humboldt remains out in front by a score of 2-1, but they have been coughing up the puck a little bit in the second period, but so far it hasn't hurt them.
Yeah, Harmon Laser-Hume has some help in front of him for sure in this period so far.
Broncos hold it in. They'll throw that towards the front of the net. That's set to the corner that time by Laser-Hume. Niven got a hold of it. He'll back it off the boards down the ice, icing again, and Thu will touch up back in the Bronco net. 14:36 to go in the second period, and we'll get a face-off right back in Flin-Flon territory, back over to the right circle, which will be the left of Harmon Laser-Hume, the SJHL goalie of the month here for November. Staggering numbers, and I asked him if this is as good as he played, and he said he's having a lot of fun, so it's always a big, big key. Here's Niven, trying to get the puck out. Knocked out by Amaral. He'll hold it in. He fired it on target. Laser-Hume will kick it in the corner. There's Chow after it again. Niven up the boards. Walker knocked it free. 2-on-1. Bakker and Silvestri. Bakker down the way. Silvestri open, and he scores! What a pass by Jacob Bakker! And the Flin-Flon Bombers have tied up the game. What a beautiful feat from Jacob Bakker. He's got the hands of a surgeon.
And what patience on that pass right there to Rob. You know what? He waited about an extra second and a half to let the defender sit back a bit more so he couldn't get his stick on it. If he would have made that pass about a second before that, that would have been an easy takeaway for the Humboldt Broncos. But great vision, great play there by Jacob Walker to be patient, wait for the lane to open up and get that pass across. All tied up 2-2 now here.
Silvestri gets his 50th of the year. What a feat by Jacob Walker. The Bombers get that big time goal. Broncos ice it after the goal. We'll see if a second assist is added.
The assist number 41, Jacob Walker.
Just the one. But a beautiful goal, and no goalie's going to stop that.
Absolutely not. He said he's going to heat up, Rob. He's got the two assists. Maybe we can smell a goal coming soon. Who knows?
Pichonito against Court. Face off of the Broncos on the Bombers. When the draw, Townshend's shot gets through, and Fisher made the save. Back of that, Arbery out front, and Bridger was there, but he couldn't locate the puck. Newlands comes back, grabs it inside his blue line, up the middle. Oh, nice pass there, but knocked away. Flin-Flon back on the attack. It's Pichonito. Pichonito down the left side, had Arbery cutting the front of the net, he'll fire it over top of the target. Puck will come back to center. Here's Laughlin, sends it back to Tanchuk. Tanchuk whiffed on that one. And now he decides to throw it deep in his own zone, which is always dangerous. Hughes is after it, but good work here by Arbery to come back and help out. Arbery to center. Hammered in. Took a funny hop. Came right back out front. Miles is there. Bridger took a run at him. Knocked down here at center ice by Strome. Tried to get that over to Hughes, but he's crossed up. Picked up by Houle. Wrapped it around the boards this time for Arbery. Hit hard this time by Skogstad. Puck goes to center. Houle will jump on this. Here's Noah Houle. Quick there across the line. Noah Houle already a goal tonight. Brings it in deep. Cook ties him up in the corner. Houle gets free, though. Back of the goal, he had Anderson with him. Couldn't get it out front to Lees, who was there. They're covering Lees. He has not had any open ice in this game. This is Cook to center. He'll hammer it in. Gets past Laser Hume, back of the net. Poked ahead here to Ashton Paul. Paul just gets it out. As he's wrapped up by a couple of Broncos, Strome will get a hold of it. He'll flip it back in, knocked down by Laser Hume. Over for Noah Houle. Houle tried to get free. Houle, look out, taken down. Penalty coming up against Humboldt. At least I think it's against the Broncos. Houle was knocked down. I've been wrong before. We'll see how the call goes here. Penalty coming up, I believe. Going to go to Lampier. And the penalty is going to be for a hooking. Wow. Third power play of the night. Flick fought a chance maybe to take the first lead of the game, Austin.
Yeah, it's a huge opportunity for them here. You know what? They weren't too successful on those first two. Didn't get too many shots. But now this third opportunity all tied up. I think they have a bit more momentum this time, and they can finally get something going, hopefully.
Faceoff in the Broncos zone is Sylvester, who's got the tying goal, lines up here for the faceoff. Bombers have been the better team for sure here in the second. Humboldt wins the draw, though. That's picked up here by Miles. His puck, first shot got knocked down. Flinfon will hold it in. Justin Lee's in there. Pins up with his guy. Sylvester trying to dig away. 12-10 to go in the period. 2-2's the score. Puck makes its way back to Noah Houle. They'll leave it there for Anderson. Oh, just holds it in. Anderson. Back to point to Houle. Across the zone to Wachler. Wachler along the left wall. Side of that for Lees, but over top of his stick. There's Anderson. He'll knock it down. Played it back to Houle. Slides the pass to Wachler. Wachler back out front to Anderson. Boy, nowhere to shoot the puck. He'll get a shot away anyway, but it's blocked. Gets the rebound. Fired that off the side of the goal. Puck back to the corner. Bombers try to center, but that's intercepted here by Mamick, and he'll get that to Skogstad. And the Broncos will get four fresh penalty killers out there as they dump the puck back in the Flin Flon zone. Wachler back to collect it. Wachler onside. Good pass to Silvestri. Silvestri tried to go wide on Constantino. Back of the goal to Anderson. He'll saucer it back to Houle. Across the zone, this is Wachler. Wachler back out front. Chip to the point. Houle knocked it down. 45 seconds to go in the power play. Chats out front for Anderson. Sharp angle. Good save that time. Fisher, he was ready for it. Broncos try to get it out. They do. Houle cut it off at center. Played it right back across the line, but Cook waited for that one, and the veteran D-man will dish it down the ice. 28 seconds to go in the power play. Here's Wachler. Quick pass to Lees at center. Lees down the right side across the Humboldt line. That one intercepted by Cook again. Back down the ice it goes. Save made. Not a lot of room out there for the power play again. 15 seconds to go. Here's the pass to Piccinino. Piccinino down the left side, flying inside the Humboldt zone. Back out front, Ashton Paul off the goal post. Oh, what a chance that was. Piccinino holds it in along the right side. Paul again, back of the goal for Bridger, trying to come back out front. Looked like Ashton Paul was going to get off the schneid there, but he hits the post. Broncos ice it. And Flin Flon 0-3 on the power play. What a chance that was.
Wow, yeah, great. And honestly, great opportunities here by the Bombers, but the Humboldt Broncos doing a great job of staying in control and staying confident and not really going too much for the puck and really closing up those lanes. And yet again, Bombers 0-3 now on the power play, like you said, but got to give credit to the Humboldt Broncos doing a great job of closing up those lanes.
Well, they got the second-best penalty kill in the league, and it's looked very good tonight. Ranked at 85.3% coming in. There's a chance off the faceoff for Egan. A weak backhander, and Fisher will make the save. 31-16. The shots right now in favor of Flin Flon, but it's a 2-2 hockey game. The Broncos led quickly 2-0, and a pair of goals here by Lanthier, but the Bombers have fought back with goals from Boole and Alexi Silvestri. He gets his 15th of the year, and by the way, Silvestri is very close to making that World Junior A team. If there would have been a camp, I heard that if he would have had a chance to go down the camp, he might have been able to make the
squad. I was surprised there wasn't any Bombers on that roster, but I guess they go for the younger guys. So.
Well, and you can only have, I believe, four 19-year-olds on the team, too. So
anyway, a great year for Silvestri nonetheless, and it won't be long before they're announcing him for a Division I scholarship, I can tell you that. Bomber throw it back across the Humboldt line. Weigel there. Olsson tried to put the pinch on him, but he'll skate it out. Weigel to center. Dished that off to Court. This is Court across the line. Didn't miss by much. Olsson back the other way. The Beeler trying to catch up with it. A poke it ahead for Egan. Egan will go after it. Egan had a big goal against Humboldt the last time that they hooked up here. Mueller can't knock it down. Puck lifted around the boards. There's Olsson. Try to push it in deep. He does. Weigel, the front side of the net. Having some trouble. Mueller ties up with him back of the goal. Puck grabbed here by Cook. Can he lift it out? No, he gave it away in front of the net. Mueller hauled down. Another penalty coming up against the Broncos. Olsson's got it. Olsson back of the net. Throws it back out to the blue line. Leppard knocked it down. Here's Chow. Lots of traffic back to Leppard. Leppard shot. Didn't miss by much. Rebound picked up by Egan. He tapped it wide. Good pressure here by the Bombers. Here's Silvestri trying to cut in. That one redirects and goes wide. And finally they blow it down. We have a hurt Humboldt Bronco back of the net. It might be the D-man too. He's down. But holy cow, another power play coming up for Flint Flon, and no doubt about that one. Mueller definitely hauled down in front of the net.
Yeah, and it looks like the Flint Flon Bombers finally starting to find the holes in this Humboldt defense. We talk about, you know, how having lots of shots, if they're not good shots, doesn't really matter. But I'd say the past 10 or 11 shots here for the Bombers have all been great opportunities for them. Just can't get any to go.
Media timeout. We'll take a break. Come back with another Bomber power play. It's all even here in the second period. This is Creighton Furniture Bomber Hockey here on 102.9 CFAR and FlintFlonOnline.com.
For a limited Claire. Time at McDonald's, enjoy a tasty breakfast trio. Your choice of sauce.
20 seconds left now.
The hash brown and a small premium roast coffee for only $5.
26.
Available before 11 a.m. at participating McDonald's restaurants in Canada. Plus, earn points on every order with the My McDonald's Rewards exclusively on the McDonald's app. Redeem points for your McDonald's favorites like McFlurries, McChickens, and more. Download the app today.
Attention. Attention.
On now at Creighton Furniture and Appliance Center, it's the Whirlpool Black Friday sales event. Create the perfect home you want with appliances that fit what you need. It's the more you buy, the more you save Black Friday sales event. Buy one, save $100. Buy two, save $250.
10 seconds.
Save $550, because the more you buy, the more you save. Now's the time to take advantage of buying Whirlpool appliances. Shop Creighton Furniture and Whirlpool.
You're on.
Save.
All righty, welcome back to Whitney Forum here. So we do have a football bomber power play coming up. I'll tell you what, this is going to be concerning for Scott Barney. It looks like Connor Thu was injured. He left the ice, and the trainer couldn't get off the ice quick enough to tend to him.
Yeah.
You didn't see what happened back here, did you?
No, I was trying to look, but it was a little bit of traffic in front there.
Anyway, Flint Flon back on the power play. They're 0-3 in this game. Poole will knock it down along the boards. This is Jacob Bachler. Side of net for Lees. Off his stick. Poole keeps it in again. Bachler once again along the wall, stops looking for someone to give it to. He'll feather the pass back of the net this time to Lees. Anderson wide open. You know where that's where they want to go. Poole. Anderson. Here it comes. He drills it. And a good save made by Fisher. I'll tell you what, that's a tough stop to make, and that was a beauty.
Fisher's really been keeping a bit in this game tonight, Robin. Like
he
I mentioned,
he scores a lot of goals right there.
That right dot is his favorite, especially on the power play. Oh, his ability to hit the angle from there is one of the best I've seen in the SJHL.
Faceoff again to the left of Fisher. It's a 2-2 game. 8.5 to go in the period. A minute 29 in the power play. Broncos do win this faceoff, and they flip that one down the ice. And Armin Laser-Hume hasn't had a lot of work in the second period. We'll drop it back to the net. This is a nice stretch pass that time, but broken up at center ice by Strome. Fired back in. Noah Hull will try again back of his own net. Minute 10 to go in the power play. 8:10 to go in the second period. 2-2 here at the Forum. Here's Bachler down the wing. His quick shot scooped up quickly like a shortstop. Good grab that time by Fisher. He'll hang on. 8:04 to play. One thing about Aiden Fisher, I don't think he's kicked out one rebound in this game.
No, I don't think he has at all. And you know what? Good on him, though, because you've got the Flint Flon Bombers coming at you, some high-quality scores. You got to be very careful which pucks you let out. So I think he's doing a great job by being pretty smart with it.
Silvestri set for the faceoff against Spencer Bell, deep in Humboldt territory. A minute one to go in the power play. Puck comes out. I think it must have hit somebody on the Bomber bench because they blew that down really quickly. So 7:59 to go. Faceoff back in Humboldt territory. So plenty of time to go in the power play, 58 seconds. The faceoff going to come outside the Bronco line. Silvestri signaling he thinks it should be inside the Humboldt zone. Mike Reagan feels the same way, but The faceoff will come outside the blue line, and Bell will line up against Silvestri. Lindfond wins the faceoff. Noah Houle will grab it at center. Here's Houle. Hammers that one in. Silvestri quickly the first guy to get it. Back of the net. Anderson tried to catch up with it. He did. Throws it back to blue line. Walker knocked it down. Quick shot. Save made. Bouncing puck at front. Right back to Houle. Holds it in. Anderson a driving score! Power play goal! And Anderson continues his outstanding play here the past couple of games. You can't keep feeding him like that in front of the net. Give Fisher credit. He stopped the first one. He couldn't stop the second one. And for Carter Anderson, that is his 19th goal of the year. Not quite his 20th. He'll get there eventually.
Wow. What a great goal. And Rob, you know, we talked about that's Carter Anderson's favorite spot, it seems to be. And I think Fisher was expecting that to go short side. Carter Anderson just ripped it across the net all the way to the far side. And just a beautiful power play goal there.
I think Bakker should be getting his third assist of the game. We'll see. Anyway, Carter Anderson on the power play. Lindfond bound to get a power play goal sooner or later. And they'll strike for the first time tonight on four opportunities. Noah Houle, the only assist. But I think that Bakker probably will get a second one at it. But the Bombers take the lead for the first time tonight, 3-2, as Court will take the faceoff against Olofsson. Back inside the Lindfond zone, bouncing puck. Broncos try to get on top of it here. We got Laughlin. He's going to get a penalty, I think. He's throwing his hands up. I didn't do it.
Guy's falling down like some dominoes over there.
Yeah, he took down Robertson there. I don't think he got a penalty. He did haul him down. I think it might be fortunate he didn't get a penalty.
He was good at hiding it. I'll give him that. At hiding it.
7:27 to go. Second period. 3-2 Lindfond in front. It was 2-0 Humboldt early here tonight. Well, the Bombers have struck back with three big goals. The latest one, a power play effort from Carter Anderson. Family from Thompson. Appreciating his fine play. He had a five-point game last night. You didn't even give him the first star.
Yes, I did.
I was told you didn't.
I did.
You changed it.
No. SJHL didn't give him the first star.
Oh, that's what it was. All right. Constantino will go back and pick it up inside the Humboldt zone. He'll flip that ahead back to center. Cut off by Tatchik. Who didn't miss by much. He ripped that right back in there. Fisher cheating along the bar there. Puck bouncing back in the Humboldt net. Oh, look out. We got Egan taking his guy down. Constantino wants a penalty. Puck is sent back in, and Egan's going to take a run at him again. Look out! He went flying at him. Constantino was ready that time. He comes back, throws a pretty good body check at Arbery, so it's starting to get physical here. Court to center, across the Bomber line. His shot went wide. Amaral will pick it up, back of the Bomber net. He's tripped up. There's a penalty coming up. The Broncos will go to the power play for just the second time tonight, Austin Mattis.
Well, Bombers have had a great penalty kill so far all season. Yesterday, they stopped Yorkton all five times, so let's see if they can do it against the Humboldt Broncos. But
a little bit better power play Humboldt has than Yorkton.
Oh, absolutely. But you know what? You see some of the physicality on both ends starting to ramp up here. But I feel like when that happens for the Bombers, that's kind of when they play their best. They use that physicality to kind of use them for motivation offensively. So glad to see those big hits there by Matt Egan.
So Humboldt, just their second power play of the game. They got a pretty good power play. It's ranked third in the league at 23%. The Bomber penalty kill ranked number one at 89%. And there's a shorthanded chance for Silvestri, who's got a goal, but it rolls off his stick. Weigel's got it. Boy, we got such a great pace again tonight. Weigel will bring it in. Weigel back with that, throws it over the corner to Nuance. Nuance will pick it up. From back the blue line, they couldn't hold it in. That's Van Blerikom. His side of center, looking for somewhere to go. Now he'll bounce it off the boards, but intercepted here by McNutt. McNutt's got it. He'll feed it back down the ice. Walker going to chase after Weigel. Fisher will come out. Look out! Walker almost stole it anyway. Boy, can he move. He'll go out for a change. Weigel will pick it up inside his own zone. A minute 18 to go in the Humboldt power play. Good move by Weigel to center. Sends it back in. Leeser Hume got a piece of it back of the goal. Picked up here by Lepper. Lepper pinned up along the boards here by Spencer Bell. One of the dangerous Humboldt Broncos on the power play. Bell leads his team in power play goals with 8. And he'll force a faceoff inside the Lindfond zone. 5:37 to go in the period. Just a minute to go in the power play. And Lindfond in front for the first time tonight, 3-2.
Fast-paced game tonight, Rob. You know what? There's been a few stoppages here and there, but a relatively quick game and fast-paced. Like we said, we expected to see a fast pace today, but you know what? They're really bringing it, an exciting game for us to watch today.
Absolutely. It's always very entertaining hockey when these two teams meet, whether it's here at the Whitney Forum or the Elgar Peterson Arena. They meet in the playoffs every single season, and you get a sense it's going to happen again this year. It's interesting. The Bombers will close out the regular season with the last two games in Humboldt this year. Constantino along the boards. That's picked up here by Court. Back to Constantino. A shot. Safe rebound. Oh, Laser Hume stretching out to take highway robbery against Amaral. He's looking to the heavens. He can't believe he didn't score. And quite frankly, neither can I.
You know what? I'll third that, Rob, because from up here, you saw the opening. Harmon Laser Hume was basically flat out on the ground. I don't know he was able to bend his body to make that save, but wow, what a goal. What a stop there by Harmon Laser Hume.
Nguyen just left the ice out, too, and the trainer going back. I think that's an equipment issue. But Nguyen's is another dangerous Humboldt Bronc on the power play. He's got 8 power play goals this year as well. So that's 2 big losses right now. No Connor Thu and no Nguyen, but I think Nguyen's is just an equipment issue, as he looked like he was going up and pretty quickly, and I think he has an equipment issue he's got to get restored. Here's Miles in the blue line. His shot, that just glanced off the post. Constantino, back of the goal for Amaral. Lost the handle to McDutt. He'll push it along the boards. We'll see if Silvestri can catch up with the puck will roll inside the Humboldt zone. Silvestri is after it with Constantino. Silvestri, good work, but he's all by himself, and Miles comes back to help out the center. Miles across the Bomber line. That's offside big time. How did they miss that? Wow. Big offside miss here. It comes back to point to Miles. He'll score to the corner. Scooped up by Amaral. Back out front of chance. Good save, Laser Hume. Puck is loose. He's got it. And now we got a big collision. Is that Niven on top of a Bronco in front of Laser Hume? There might be more penalties being handed out. But a bad miss offside by the officials here tonight, Austin Mattis.
Yeah, you know what? I've seen that too. The linesman was right there. I saw him right at the line, so I don't know how you missed that, but luckily for the Humboldt Broncos, they...
For Flint Flon, you mean?
Yeah, well, luckily for Flint Flon that they don't get scored on, but also luckily for Humboldt that they don't call that, so it could have been really bad for the Bombers if they would have scored there.
That was horrible missed call. Anyway, 4:39 to go. Still 2 seconds to go in the Humboldt power play. Nazareth out there for the faceoff against Piccinino. The left to Harmon Laser Hume. Flint Flon in front for the first time tonight, 3-2. They win the draw. Noah Hull will get a hold of it, and he'll get it down to center. Arbery out of the box. We're back to 5-5, and Humboldt 0-2 in the game. Here's Hull. Feeds it back here to Lepper. Nice pass to Niven. He'll kick that one ahead, but took a funny hop and came back to center. Niven tried to knock it down. Hughes got a hold of it. Niven gets it back. He's pushed off the puck. Looked like he wanted to shovel it ahead with his glove, but if he does that, they'll blow it down, but he gets back up, and Nazareth will get a stick on it. He'll redirect it back in Flint Flon territory. Bombers play it ahead. Niven gets it up the right side here for Arbery. He'll get it inside Humboldt territory. Arbery along the wall has Piccinino with him, but the Broncos break that up, and they'll get it out. Good defense by them. Nazareth to center. Lost the handle. Picked up here by Arbery. Off the boards. Back down in Humboldt territory. Icing against Flint Flon. 3:49 to go in the second period. Let's see what's happening out of town here tonight. Melford ahead of Notre Dame 4-1. That's late in the second period. LaRange has built up a 3-0 lead on Yorkton with about 7 minutes to go in the second period. Kindersley up on Estevan 4-2. That went midway through the second period tonight. And Battleford a 2-0 lead on Melville late in the second period as we take a look at our McDonald's out-of-town scoreboard. 3-2 here off the faceoff. A quick chance and just ripped wide by Van Blerikom. Didn't miss by much there, and I think that would have had Laser Hume beat. He reacted pretty slow on it.
Yeah, I don't think he was ready for that
shot
at all.
He was right off the faceoff like that. Good play. They'll try again. Another faceoff back inside the Flint Flon zone. Bombers sending out some new recruits as Bridger will come out in the line of Paul, Lees, and Anderson come out there. Anderson, of course, the go-ahead goal here on the power play in the second period. 34-23, by the way, the shots right now. In Flint Flon's favor as well. So Lee's set for the faceoff against Lanther, who's got both Humboldt goals. Off the draw, here's Anderson, played it ahead to Paul. Paul hit a post earlier tonight. That one taken away from him, sent back inside the Flint Flon zone. There's Hull. Had to be careful. Van Blerikom got in tight on him. They'll push it ahead to Anderson, a backhand pass right back to Paul, the center. Here's Ashton Paul quickly across the Yorkton line. His chance will redirect off Weigel, go over the glass and out of play. 3:23 to go in the second period. 3-2, Flint Flon in front, but a good game again.
I say, it looks like Humboldt's finally starting to get a few more shots on net this period, obviously, with that power play, but Bombers doing a great job of really getting in front and giving Harmon Laser Hume the help he needs today, for sure.
Big faceoff in the Broncos zone. The left of Fisher leaves back out there for Flint Fawn. No points. It's one of the first games in a long while he hasn't registered a point. And again, the SJHL points leader entering play tonight. He and Kean Bell, the top two performers this year. Leaves with 45 points. Bell right behind him with 40, but has only played 15 games. What a year. Here's Anderson back the other way. We're expecting to get back in the top 10 here very soon. Ranked 15th in the league right now with 28 points, but he had 5 points last night. He's got one tonight. Boy, he's been on some kind of a tear, really since the showcase, been on a real big tear.
You know what? And his parents were at the game watching yesterday. They saw them sitting up here beside you, Rob, and they couldn't have been more ecstatic about his play. And you know what? I feel like having his parents here definitely helps out his play. And clearly yesterday with that five-point game, absolutely amazing.
Olofsson against Skogstad. That's inside the Humboldt zone. Took a Flint Fawn bounce. Olofsson's down. Here comes Mamick inside the Flint Fawn zone. Mamick a shot. Good. Nice glove stop that time. Laser Hume, who's had to stay razor sharp. He hasn't had a lot of work here in this second period.
Ryan, Rob, just to touch on what you said about Justin Lees. Actually has scored in 9 games straight. He's had a goal. Not just scored a point. He's gotten a goal in 9 games straight so far. So right now, his only game in, this means 10th game. If he scores today, it'll be 10 in a row. But right now, nothing for him. So.
Well, they're not giving him any room. And I know that they thought the last time that they were here, that, well, he was a big factor in those 2 games, right? They've had been trying to put somebody on him not to give him the room. And it's worked so far, but that should open up room for other guys. And so far, so good. Puts on the 3-2 lead. Here's Anderson trying to get it across the line. Poked away from him. Grabbed quickly by Bell at center. Bell across the bottom line. Leg rip. Good save. Kicked away that time, Laser Human. Another penalty coming up here. I think Lee's the captain, going to go for a hook. So Humboldt, or so it's going to be Chichu Laughlin, the defenseman. So Humboldt back on the power play for the third time here tonight. They came close the last time they had the power play.
Well, yeah, I saw Chichu Laughlin there. He was right beside him. I guess the ref must have seen something I did, but I guess he hooked him up a little bit on that rebound and prevented him from getting the puck, but...
Newlands has come back out there. It looks like he's still having a skate issue here. But he's got 8 power play goals, so he's going to come out there. They didn't have him for the last power play. We mentioned he's got 8 power play goals this year.
Comes out when you need it most.
Along, of course, with Spencer Bell. So 16 power play goals between those two guys, and they're out there right now. Legal shot, deflects off front, puck laying there. The Bombers clear to the boards, but not out. Vedler, come a shot. That goes wide. Newlands will hold it in. Back of the goal for Bell. Like we said, these guys lethal with the extra attacker, but that one stripped away. Bouncing puck down the ice. Fisher will make the save, and Weigel will take over back of his own net. Here comes Weigel. He'll skate it to center. Dished it off to Bell. Got to come back out front to Weigel. Weigel in the corner took a good hit, but got it back to Bell. Van Blerikon. He took a whack at it in the corner as well. Looked like the Bombers do get it. Picked up eventually by Silvestri. He'll rip it down the ice. Minute 17 to go in the power play. Just under 2 minutes to go in the second period. Lanthier goes back to get it. He'll drop it back of the goal. Van Blerikon has it. And now he'll leave it there. And the Broncos send the pass to Miles to center. Across the zone. Broken up here by Lepper. And he'll flip it back in. Here's Olofsson. Coming down on Constantino. Constantino will pick it up. 51 seconds to go on the power play. Constantino puts it to his own blue line. Feeds it to Court at center. Court inside the Flint Fawn zone. There's Bridger along the boards. Took a hop back to Constantino. A chance. Redirection. Great save. Harmon Laser Hume. Hughes with the redirection there. And the Broncos keep it in. Still good. Lots of power play time left. 39 seconds. And a minute 21 to go in the second period is Anderson and Tancha come out there to aid the other two penalty killers, McNutt and Justin Lees. So the face-off again inside the Flint Fawn zone to the right of Harmon Laser Hume. Amaral against Lees. Lees wins the draw. Quickly picked up here by Tancha. He'll lift it down the ice. Lees trying to fly in there. Gets past the game. That it gets on goal. But Fisher comes out and pokes it ahead. Close that time. Court. Back to Amaral across the Bomber line. Knocked away by Anderson. He'll clear it the length of the ice. 18 seconds to go in the Humboldt power play. A minute to go in the period. Flint Fawn continues to lead this game 3-2. This is Constantino to Nasworth at center. McNutt back. Ball's down. Puck comes back inside the zone. McNutt got it back. Pushed to the blue line, but held in by Miles. Miles in the corner. Picked up that time by Nazareth. Penalty is over. Laughlin back on the ice. Rockles had the puck inside the Bombers' zone, though. As Miles will let that one rip, it goes wide. Here's Cook. He'll pick it up and shovel the backhander in. Less than 30 seconds to go in the period. Good pressure by the Broncos here at the end of the period, trying to even things up before we take a break. Broncos throw it out front. Amaral was open, but he couldn't pick it up. Cook shot. That one hit Amaral out front. Grabbed by Anderson, who still can't clear. Amaral keeps it in. Good pressure here by Humboldt. There's Miller. Pass out front. Hit a skate. Laughlin finally clears it. Off the glass, and it's going to go on net. Fisher comes out to play it. They'll get it back to center. Knocked away by McNutt. McNutt, oh, they run out of time. As he hits Niven with the pass, but the buzzer goes. And if you're the Bombers, you got to be happy. They were down at 1.2-0, but a storm back with three and hanging on to a 3-2 lead here after two periods of play.
Yeah, quite the impressive period there for the Bombers. Not, absolutely not perfect, as I always like to say, but you know what? Great period. You know, being down two goals, they got that one, and now they come back and be up 3-2. I don't know why they do this to themselves every game, Rob. Go down a couple goals in the first period. I don't know if they're trying to test themselves for what it is, but I think that's the one issue this Bombers team's got to work on is those bad starts. But rather than that, I think they've played a pretty solid game so far.
Great game both ways. It always is when these two teams get together. Flint Fawn a 3-2 lead. We'll take a break. Come back with the second intermission show for the co-op. And, of course, our second intermission featuring an interview with Rory McGoran from the SJHL as well. So lots of stuff to look forward to here tonight. Creighton Furniture Bomber Hockey will continue on 102.9 CFER and flintfawnonline.com.
Clear.
Bailey Homes provides a ready-to-move home
Six.
To you and your family. From the expertise of planning, the quality of the build, to the care of the move, let Bailey Homes make your dream home a reality. All customized to fit your needs, they allow you to take the stress out of home construction and spend more time making everlasting memories. Family owned and operated with experiences in the North, visit bailey-homes.ca or call 204-903-5220.
It's your space, your style, and Shane's understands that. With Samsung Appliances, Shane's has the product that will work for you. Need compact? They have it. Want a unique color? They have it. Maybe you want all freezer in a stand-up, or all fridge because you don't like squeezing in your groceries. They have it. Or maybe you want something even smarter than you, an appliance that makes life easier and can help organize your family's day. Shane's and Samsung have it. What are you waiting for? Get to Shane's and shop Samsung Appliances, because it's your space, your style, and they have it.
Northland Ford proudly supports the Flin Flon Bombers throughout the SJHL season. We know that the Bombers will play tough like the Ford F-150, the toughest truck on the market for over 40 years. Northland Ford helping the community cheer on the Bombers as they work to bring a championship to the best fans.
10 seconds.
And they provide you with the best selection on their lot. In the North, for the North, Northland Ford, the dealership you tell your friends about.
And you're on.
All righty, we're back here at the Whitney Forum for the second intermission. Rob Hart joined here by Austin Mattis tonight as we take a look at the second period scoring summary. It was 2-1 Humboldt after one. The Bombers do weather the early storm, kill off that early Humboldt power play. And boy, the nicest goal tonight, perfect give and go between Walker and Silvestri. Picture perfect saucer pass. Silvestri not going to miss it tight like that. Grabbing his 15th of the year to tie the game.
Yeah, it was a beautiful goal. And like I said, the most impressive thing about that was the patience on Jacob Walker on that pass. You know what? A lot of people, they see that pass. First thing they want to do when they see that 2-on-1 is try and get that pass there as soon as possible. But sometimes that's not the right thing. You got to wait for that lane to open up a little bit, let the defender drag back a bit. That's exactly what he did, put the pass through. And like you said, Alexi Silvestri, he's going to finish that 99 times out of 100. So beautiful goal there.
Carter Anderson would get another power play goal as he would be set up just outside his office, just inside the left circle. You know, Aiden Fisher made a heck of a save off him in the identical spot just before that. Not going to stop him twice. He rifles it off the post and in. Four goals last night, a goal tonight. His 19th of the year. Buckler and the second assist, I believe, was given to Hull. Yeah, the defenseman. So there we go. Buckler and Hull assisting on that one at the 12:20 mark. Humboldt, a couple late power plays. Came close. Haven't been able to get one past Harmon Laser Hume. So Flin Flon in front, 3-2. Shots, 17-16 Bombers. It's 35-27 Flin Flon through two. The Bombers 1-for-4 in the power play. Humboldt 0-for-3, and it's that one power play goal, the big difference right now.
Yeah, and you know, we knew that was going to happen, especially when you have a strong power play like the Flin Flon Bombers here. And Carter Anderson, as we talked about earlier, that right dot is his favorite spot to shoot from. And I will say, Aiden Fisher been very impressive. And Great thing by Carter Anderson. What he did there is when you go for that cross crease on that power play goal, you expect it to go the short side, the open side. Aiden Fisher, he hugged that post as tight as he could. Carter Anderson shoots it to the far side, which is way more open, but the harder shot to hit, but made for a beautiful goal.
Flint-Flon leads it 3-2 when they lead after 40 minutes of play this year. Their record is 19-0-2.
Woo.
When Humboldt trails after two, their record this year is, doesn't happen very often, 0-3-1. It's only one goal deficit. Going to be a fun third period. We'll take a break. Rory Burgoyne from the Broncos and the SJHL joins us next here on 102.9 CFAR and FlintFlonOnline.com.
How does KFC make original recipe chicken taste so good? Their trained cooks hand-bred premium grain-fed Canadian chicken for their original recipe on the bone, which is raised without any hormones in a secret recipe of 11 herbs and spices. They use only trans-fat-free Canadian canola oil to cut the saturated fat in the food without sacrificing taste, and it's cooked in small batches throughout the day. This ensures that the chicken is always fresh, just the way the Colonel wanted it. KFC. So good.
Hud Bay is proud to be a sponsor of this Bomber broadcast. From donations for bursaries, hockey schools, clubs, community events, charities, and so much more, Hud Bay has supported our community with dedication and generosity, contributing to events and organizations. Hud Bay thanks the people of Flin Flon for their continued support.
You're on.
And welcome to our second intermission, joined, of course, by the play-by-play voice, one of the key voices in the SJHL, Rory Burgoyne, of course, hosting lots of different stuff around the league on social media. And, Rory, here we are, the Flin Flon Bombers, Humboldt Broncos once again. It was just a couple weeks back. Bombers won both games, but pretty competitive, and I really think at least that first game, Humboldt probably thought that they deserved a little bit of a better fate. I have to ask you this. There's been so many games between these two teams the last couple of years, and Humboldt plays well, but Flin Flon seems to be getting the results compared to the Broncos do. In your opinion, Rory, what's been the difference? I mean, let's touch back to the two games this year, even the last couple of seasons. I mean, in your opinion, what's been the difference between the winning and losing?
The two games in this season, I just think you give your guys an inch and they take a mile, right? When you actually look at the underlying numbers, it favored the Broncos in terms of expected goals for, in terms of danger scoring chances. But then, you know, the ones that went in the net weren't for the Broncos. It was Justin Leeds. You give him a little room, he's burying it, right? So Flin Flon just really, really good at capitalizing on the chances that you give them, which is how you beat them. You can't give them grade A chances. I know there's going to be a couple of game, but you know, if you can limit those to counting them on one hand, then that's the only way you're going to beat them, because their offense is so high powerful that if again, you give them an inch, they're going to take a mile. And yeah, I just think that was kind of the difference, because I thought it was a 2-1 hockey game. I thought it was a 1-0 hockey game, 3-2, right? Not a 5-1 and a 5-2 game when you go back and watch them. Really competitive. I expect more of the same, but you can't give them those room and those opportunities because they're going to score on you.
You know, you look at this Humboldt Bronco team, and how can't you be excited? I mean, it's still relatively pretty young, and it's one of the better teams in the league. I mean, yeah, Thu having a great year. Bryson's come in. Van Blerikov, of course, going to get a chance to go play now in that World Junior A Challenge. You got Motu. The list goes on and on. I don't think anybody was surprised that Humboldt would have a good team, but when you think about it, Rory, could be the start to something special. I mean, this is a team that's going to have a lot of guys around for a while, and they're pretty competitive right now.
Yeah, I've really been impressed with, you know, the youthfulness, and not only that, their ability to step up into the lineup and contribute immediately, right? Even guys on the bottom line, so-called bottom line, Merrick Mamich, Braden Skogstad, all know their roles right out of the gate and all excel in them really well. I've been impressed with how physical they are as a young team. Usually that takes a little bit of maturity coming into the SJ. It's a more physical league. It's, more of an adult kind of league as the past few years, but maybe that youthfulness is growing in across the 12 teams. But again, in those two games here, I thought the Broncos were the more physical team against the Flin Flon Bombers, and you can't say that very often with the team that you guys have. But yeah, I've been really impressed with what they've been doing. They went through a little bit of a November, one step forward, one step back kind of, I wouldn't even call it a slump. They ended up 6-5 in the month of November, but you know, they need to have learning lessons. They need to play tough games. They need to lose games in order to learn how to win them more frequently, right? But it's as good as a team, you know, as I've seen so far. And I expect some big things, especially after the Christmas break, once, you know, just continues to grow with that chemistry and that experience.
You mentioned physical play. Has that been one of the things that's been lacking in their game maybe the last couple of years? Because, I mean, you go back to last season, I mean, a lot of people thought Humboldt might actually win the league. You're the only team in the league to beat Battleford more than one time.
Yeah.
You seem to have their number. And you know, but Flin Flon just seems to be that Achilles heel the past couple of years. Has the physical play been one thing that's lacked in their game the last few years that they've been able to kind of grasp for this season?
They've always had the physical players, but maybe not consistently through the 200-foot game, which I think is more evident in this lineup. So whether that's physicality in the defensive zone, you know, winning puck battles down low, or, of course, on the forecheck, really wearing down opposition defenses, I think that's what stands out apart from other teams. They still have some high-end scoring talent. They still have the Matthew Van Blaercombs, the Cage Nuance, but they brought in a lot of really complete 200-foot players that really just adds to the kind of physical style, but responsible in all three zones is what I think separates this team from last team.
Let's talk about Benjamin Motu. I mean, his numbers are pretty good for the good chunk of the season. He's been number one in some of the big stats. Harmon Laser-Hume has caught fire lately and the number one goalie right now, but I think they're pretty happy with Motu. Playoff experience last year, he wasn't really the go-to guy when it began. They had to go to him. We all know the situation. How important was that, even in a losing cause, just to get some playoff experience?
Yeah, it's been huge. And, you know, Motu had such an incredible offseason. He, you know, lost like 20 pounds of weight, right? Really took care of his diet, really took care of his workout programs. And he's come back so determined. And, you know, goaltender of the month in the first month and a half in the SJHL again. And then, you know, he kind of was fighting the puck for the last few games. So then Aiden Fischer stops in. And after this game, he's going to have enough minutes to being considered a qualified goaltender when you look at the stats. And, you know, if he has another performance like he has all season, he will actually be number one in goals against and in save percentage. So that's the year that the rookie, technically backup goalie, has been having. So the Broncos got a 1-2 punch as good as any in this league. So whether it's Motu, whether it's Fisher, I think it'll be Fisher tonight. Both are ready to kind of take the reins whenever they're called upon.
And he's had a taste in this building, too, because he did play one of the two games when Humboldt was here a couple weeks back.
Yeah, played one of the two games here, played one of the two games in LaRange that we just came out of Thursday and yesterday. Both goaltenders, yeah, as I said, they're ready. Motes is fired up whenever he's playing, and Fish has looked great in his eight games so far this season. So goaltending is not a problem for the Broncos this year. It's just limiting those scoring chances. You can't give them to Flin Flon, and that's what we're going to try to do tonight.
It'll be very interesting to see what happens. Of course, every time that these two teams get together, it's always extra special. We talked a lot about Flin Flon Humboldt. You cover the league better than anybody, Rory. You know everything that's going on. Let's talk about some of the other teams. I mean, you and I were talking about this before it went to air. I really like this Nipwin Hawks team. I like their forward group. I mean, they added that player from the Ukraine. You know, they were able to grab one of the Blizzard's top scorers from last year. He hasn't quite caught fire yet, but they made a trade and brought a defenseman in today in McGinnis, who's got a pretty good pedigree if he could stay healthy. Mm-hmm. This Nipwin Hawks team, could they be scary in the second half of the season?
Yeah, 100%. They were kind of scary in the second half of last season, too, as a youthful team. And then, you know, faced the Broncos in the first round of the playoffs. That was not an easy series. If you look at just the games, Broncos won in five games, but was not easy by any stretch of imagination. You can't say Nipwin are a youthful team anymore. They actually have 9 20-year-olds and one above since bringing in McInnes. So I'm not sure which one of Tad Cozen is going to have to kind of, you know, part ways with eventually. But the thing is that the Nipwin Hawks have seven of their eight before acquiring McInnes up front in the forward unit for 20-year-olds. So their back end, I still think, is a little bit inexperienced. Ronan Buchberger and Vito Biondo are as good as pairing in this league as you'll find. Behind that, they're struggling to keep the puck out of their own net a bit. But once that kind of shores up, and I know it will, bringing McInnes in is a huge addition on their blue line to not only add out offense, but if he stays healthy, he can play a lot of minutes, a leader as well. So Nipwin's is a dangerous team, as a lot of people expected to have that growth year this year. And, I wouldn't want to play them in the playoffs. But, again, they can, you know, tons of offense, and that's the system Tad Cozen has. But on defense, I just think they're looking for a little bit more security.
We'll have to wait and see what happens. You mentioned LaRange. You just have come, of course, just played them, beat them back-to-back nights. So this is a team that's really struggled this year. May not make the playoffs. I don't know what they're going to have to do to turn things around. They have a number of players that have decided they don't want to play there. I know they made that trade with Flin Flon earlier this year. Two-thirds of those guys are gone already. Can you kind of put your finger on what's going on in LaRange this season?
They can't keep the puck out of their net, right? And they can't keep the pucks away from their net. They average the most shots against their goaltenders per game at like 43 shots, which, I mean, no team is going to win over 500 allowing that much traffic in front of their goaltenders no matter how good they are. They're not going to stop 41 out of 43 every night. They're going to get worn out. So that's problem number one is, you know, too much traffic in front. They're not able to win puck battles down low. They're kind of getting worn down. They have enough pieces. They have enough talent. I love Parker Layton. I love Mason Buchert, Jacob Cassette. There's so many pieces on there that if they put it together, I wouldn't be surprised. But right now it just seems that you know, they can't outscore their problems. And I know we've talked about that on SJHL Weekly. It's tough going for the LaRonge Ice Wolves right now, but what are they, 27 games, I think, into the season, and they're 7-17, so they're going to have to win, you know, 18 of the last 24 games or something like that. It's tough, but I don't count out Killer Kaminsky. I don't count out Kyle Schneider, so it's possible. They're never out of it. They're only about 9 points back of a playoff line right now, but the defensive woes, if we talk about Nipawin, it's tenfold there in LaRonge.
Yeah, I remember. I haven't seen him since the beginning of the season, but that was I've never seen that offense like that from two teams away. It was going back and forth. It reminded me of minor hockey. Yeah. I mean, the scores were over 20 goals each game. So quickly before we wrap it up, the battle for Stars, of course, Kian Bell has made them an instant contender once again. They're playing very well. This guy, it's incredible the amount of points. I'm serious. I haven't seen anybody put up the numbers he has since Wayne Gretzky back in the 80s with the amount of games and points that this guy. How's he doing it?
He's just a cerebral player, and he seems to put himself in the positions to find those points, right? When I watch Kian Bell and I watch Justin Lees is 100% more dynamic than Kian Bell is. He controls the game. I don't think Kian Bell controls the game of the Battle for Snore Stars, but he's so smart, and he's got such a great release and, you know, cerebral, as we said, to kind of put himself in positions and really set up his teammates where if Justin Lees wants to take a loop, take a couple hard strides, turn it on and score himself, he's going to do that. Kian Bell, I think, a little bit less in that regards, but, again, the hockey IQ is off the charts, and that's why you're seeing him already third in the league scoring in, you know, 10 less games than the guys above him.
And a couple of points for Kian Bell again here tonight. We're underway in the third period. A big thanks to Roy McGoran for joining us. Always great to get his expertise. He follows the league, like we said. I guess maybe Neugenbauer and Notre Dame might be the only guy that knows more about the league than he does, but those guys are definitely tops for sure. And they zero things down pretty good. And this Humboldt team, a very good hockey club, but very young. And like I said, Austin Manis, it could be the cornerstone for what could be a real powerhouse here for the next couple of seasons. We're underway. Flint on a 3-2 lead. Van Vlerikom, a big part of that puzzle. Only 17 years old, gets it on net. Here's Cook's shot. Gets blocked here by Niven. Niven's got it, waiting for some people to get onside here. He'll shovel it in deep. Hull tried to get in there, but he broke in too late. Cook gets the blue line. Hull will chop it, get it in here to Silvestri. He's pinned up in the corner by Weigel. Knocked away by Piccinino. Piccinino's had some good bursts in this game, but Cook came over and took it away from him. He'll flip around the boards to Nguyen's. Bombers try to hold it in. Puck is bouncing. Nguyen's will get the blue line, but knocked away. Fed back in by Hull. Cook been out there a long time. Might be a little bit tired as he does his best to hang on the puck. They do get it free from him. Piccinino. Back of the goal, it goes to Arbery. Arbery will pick it up. Chopped it back of the net. Weigel takes his guy down. That's Bridger. Puck lifted down the ice. Leppard lets it go by him. There's Miller behind the D. But he's way offside. And they'll blow that down with 18:09 to go here in the third period. Let's see what's happening with the McDonald's out-of-town scoreboard tonight. Battleford, like we said, Kian Bell on both goals tonight. Melville scored, so Battleford leads it 2-1 in the third period. We've got Kindersley, a 5-2 lead on Estevan after two. LaRonge blanking Yorkton 5-0 after two. And Melford, a 4-1 lead on Notre Dame in the third period. 3-2, Flin Flon leads it here. Laughlin at center will slap the puck back inside Humboldt territory. Brock Mueller there to jump on that. Mueller back of the goal. Puck stripped away from him and picked up this time by Mamick. Mamick to center will flip it in. Laser Hume stopped that. Grabbed it to Tanchuk, who lost it at the side of the net. Picked up here by Laughlin. Ahead to Mueller. He gets cranked by Mamick. Big body check there. Miles after it. Off the partition. Wayne behind the play. Penalty coming up here to Egan. And I think he took Miles down. Miles is in all kinds of discomfort. He's down on the ice here, Austin Mattis. And I didn't see it. I wonder if this will be a hit to the head or not. But Miles is hurt and he's laid out.
Oh, boy. You never like to see those ones.
We're going to take a break here. 7:36 to go. Didn't see it in behind the play. But Miles, they're attending to it. Hopefully he's okay. This is Crate Furniture Flin Flon Bomber Hockey here on 102.9 CFAR and FlinFlonOnline.com.
The North of 53
Clear.
Co-op invites you to take a moment and think about those way back Christmas memories. Maybe you were just a kid, or maybe you saw something like it on TV. People all gathered around for the holiday season, enjoying good company and good food. The co-op can help you make new memories with an expertly arranged deli tray, a bevy of gourmet cheeses, and of course, sweet treats. It's the reason folks come on over, or the reason you pop by, because especially at Christmas at the North of 53 Co-op, you're at home there.
RAG 1987 Limited in the Paw now have ultra-quiet generators in stock for any purpose. The ultra-quiet 1000i is one of the quietest gas-powered generators on the market, delivering 1,000 watts of power. The 3000iES features the Honda Eco throttle system, offering amazing fuel efficiency, lasting 7 to 20 hours on a single tank. From recreation
to industrial,
get your hands on a Canadian-built and tested Honda generator at RAG 1987. Limited in the Paw, your local Honda dealer.
You're on.
All righty, welcome back to Whitney Forum. Good news, Miles is back on his feet and made his way to the Humboldt bench, and 2 minutes is on the board. So I wonder if this is going to be a 2 and a 10, because they've had a long discussion about this, and it was just a routine 2 minute penalty.
Don't think it would take that long.
Yeah, so I'm thinking there's got to be more to it than that. We didn't see it, it was in behind the play, but the best news of all is that Miles is up. Here's the announcement on it. Just a 2 minute boarding penalty.
Okay.
I didn't see it, so I can't comment on it, but it is a Humboldt power play, and they are on the power play for the fourth time tonight. This is Weigel. He'll skate with it to center, quickly across the bomber line. He can really rush the puck. He'll throw it on target. Kicked away by Harmon Laser. Him. That one hit the official. Picked up by Bachler. Look out. The bomber's got something going shorthanded. Bachler. Oh, he waited too long, and Silvestri goes behind him. Boy, nice play developing there. Silvestri gets it back again. Silvestri back in the net. Held up here, tried to get it free, but that's dug free here by Van Blarikom to center. He'll skate with it inside the Flin-Flon zone. Going to go wide here on Lepper. He'll rip it around the boards. Flin-Flon will pick it up again, and unfortunately that's flipped up into their bench, and we'll get a faceoff back inside the Flin-Flon zone. So 107 to go. Boy, that looked pretty good. Walker got that. It looked like a 2-on-1, but he kind of hung on it a little extra long. I think he's trying to see what the defenseman was going to do, how he's going to commit, and the defenseman played it perfectly.
No, absolutely. Unfortunate for the Humboldt Broncos, the refs kind of helped out the Flin-Flon Bombers there. The weird bounce off the ref goes right into the hands of Bachler. And like you said, great opportunity for the Bombers, but you know what? Great played by the defenseman there.
Humboldt remains on the power play, 101 remaining with the extra attacker, 16 and a half to go. The Broncos have it. This is Newlands. Like we said, 8 power play goals for him. Send it through traffic. He had a guy open back door. It was Van Blarikom. Just missed the pass. That's in if he picks it up cleanly, because Laser Hume was on the other side of the net. Newlands, side of the net again. Here's a chance for Spencer Bell. Turned aside. Newlands, a shot. Glove save made. Laser Hume tosses it back. Seems to be on top. And look at the shots now, Austin. All of a sudden, 35-32. Flin-Flon. Humboldt. They come out here pretty good in the third period.
Yeah, not as much volume as you'd expect from the Bombers in the last 5 minutes here. But like I said, this Humboldt Broncos team, they're a great team here. And they're definitely testing the Bombers right now. But Harmon Laser Hume really holding on here for the Bombers.
Amaral takes the faceoff against Silvestri. Gets it back to Constantino. He didn't miss by much. Walker again will poke it out. He's been so good tonight on these penalty kills. Walker down the wing. Scott shoots it on target. Save made. Rebound. And he can't grab it in front of his net, but it's picked up instead here by Constantino. Constantino right up the middle of the ice, back down to the point to Amaral, just holds it in. It's over to Hughes. Hughes throws it out front, partially blocked here by Bachler. And his first shot gets blocked. He gets the second one down the ice. It goes, and there's Niven in there. I don't think Fisher knew he was in there at all. Niven comes back, gets a piece of it. Penalty over, Egan under the box. We're back to 5-a-side. Miller will carry it in across the bomber line. Knocked away by Tancha. Dangerously skates in front of his own net. He's hauled down, and we're going to have another penalty coming up here. And the Bombers going to go to the power play for the fifth time after killing off that fourth Bronco power play.
You know, and I don't know if the Hogs, I don't think the Humboldt Broncos are doing it on purpose, but you know what? Not the penalties they need to be taking right now.
No, this has been, out of all the games that I've seen from Humboldt, one of the more undisciplined games I've seen them play.
No, and you know, and out of over the past 2 years I've been here, all the games I've seen them play, they're all one of the most disciplined teams most of the time, but today it's just been very silly penalties, and obviously they're not doing it on purpose.
No, there hasn't been any marginal calls. I mean, pretty much everything they've called for the most part has been a penalty. Anyway, we'll see if the Bombers can take advantage. They're going to go back to the extra attacker again. Fifth chance tonight. Flint Fawn 1-for-4. Silvestri, Anderson, Lees, Buckler, and Noah Hull. Broncos win the faceoff. Can't clear. Noah Hull's got it. Along the boards to Buckler. Buckler to the front of that. Picked up here by Lees. Out front, Anderson. He scores again. Another power play goal by number 27. Oh, the mastery continues here. Six goals in the last two games. Carter Anderson, what a season. That's goal number 20.
He is just unbelievable, Rob, honestly. And, like, you know what? Like you guys were talking about in that interview, his positioning, similar to Key and Bell, his IQ is so high, and his ability to be able to read where the puck is going to go, whether it's off a pass, off the boards, or on rebounds, that is what separates him. And even there, you just saw perfect positioning in that right circle to get that perfect shot.
I believe Justin Lees will get an assist. It'll be his first point of the night. This is McNutt at center. Up the middle, Flint Flom in front, 2-4-2, back-to-back power play goals here by Carter Anderson. Flint Flom will keep it in. We go back to the net, pinned up along the boards. Miles will rip it out to the point. Knocked down by Chow. Justin Lees, there it is. And Buckler, another assist tonight, third for him. And Flint Flom leads this game 4-2. Miles will knock it down, and some of the Broncos going to start bringing the house now. Miles across the line, fanned on it. Chow throws into the corner. That's picked up here by Mamick. Pinned up along the board. There's Mueller in there trying to get a stick on it. He's trying to get away here from Strom. Good work by Strom to poke it free. Racing back is Egan inside his own zone. The official was there. They had to kind of try to avoid him. And they'll get it off the boards back down inside the Humboldt zone. Olofsson almost stole that. Here's Strom to center. Knocked away that time by Bridger. They'll get the loose puck and fire it back down in Flint Flom territory. Grabbed here by McNutt. Plays it ahead to Bridger. Bridger at center. Sends it back inside the Broncos zone. Chipped ahead that time by Constantino. Here's Leppard. Back across the line. Took a hit. Coughed the puck up. And here comes Court. Arbery, though, back to get a hold of him. Bridger plays it back to Piccinino. Piccinino at center tries to get free. Can't get the puck to settle down, but got it across the line anyway. Piccinino still poking at it. Ran at that time by Nazareth. But comes to center. Back to the Bomber blue line. That's Leppard. He'll feed that one over to Hull. Over to Bridger. Across the line. His quick shot. Stopped here by Fisher. In and out of his glove. But he'll grab it and hang on. So 13:34 to go in the hockey game. And a big insurance goal here. Another power play marker courtesy of Carter Anderson. What a weekend performance by him. Four goals last night. Two and maybe counting tonight.
Yeah, you know what, Rob? I would not doubt it if he got another one tonight. His, just like I said, his ability to find the openings on the ice and just get to the perfect spots, whether it's on the rebounds or the passes, it's phenomenal. Such a pleasure to watch.
Nevin, Silvestri, and Buckler, the forward group. It's Tanchuk and Lapfoot on the back end. Silvestri lining up for the faceoff against Hughes. Bombers win the draw. Can't hold it in. Tanchuk sold it well, but he definitely came across the blue stripe, and that's blown down with 13:31 to go here in the third period.
And the Bombers finally starting to get some shots, obviously, with the great goal there. But you know what? Looks like Humboldt has some chance of charging back there, but now Bombers have control of the game.
Still plenty of hockey to go. 13 and a half minutes remaining as Court will send that one in, but it hit somebody, so icing is waved off. Bombers quickly back to the offensive. Jacob Buckler down the wing, trying to throw that back up front to Niven, cut off by Nazareth. Nazareth down the wing, throws that little bit behind guy Hughes, and he'll fire it on target. The save made with Court cutting in the front of the net. That's blown down with 13:09 to go. 38:32, by the way, the shots. And, you know, you talk about this great rivalry between the Bombers and Broncos. Last 5 years, Flint Flom's played them pretty tough. Flint Flom 10-5-1-2, and that's just the regular season. Last 3 years in the playoffs when they met, the Bombers are 12-2, haven't lost a game at the Elgar Peterson Arena.
Wow.
Both games in the playoffs that Humboldt won been here at the Whitney Forum.
I remember that from last year. Huge games for the Bombers last year.
The Bombers have found a way to be on the better end of these scores against Humboldt. Sometimes they're outplayed, outshot, but they just always find a way, and they've done that again tonight. Remember, they spotted the Broncos the first two goals again, but have stormed back with four. They do have the 4-2 lead here with just over 13 minutes to go. There's a chance for Robertson on target. Big rebound, Laser Hume, but the rebound chopped outside the zone, and Miles will go back to get it inside the Humboldt blue line. Paul on top of him. Going to come back to Lanther. That'll be an icing call. Leppert will touch up back of the bomber net, and I like this Luke Leppert. He's going to be a star in this league.
Yeah, he's been playing unbelievable. You know what? I'm just kind of... His IQ is so great on the defensive end, and this, that makes such a big difference. Obviously, he's not getting tons of goals right now, but he does the little things so right.
Well, like you mentioned, how he was a key for them getting that first goal here tonight.
And it's all those little things, the hustle plays that make the difference.
Bombers try to keep it off the faceoff. Good work here by Anderson, too, tonight. Comes back in for Lees. Lees throws a big body check that time on Lanthier. Puck will come down the ice. And McNutt will... grab it back of his net. It's an icing call again. 12 and a half to go. Third period. Humboldt's last visit here for the regular season. The Bombers will have to make three visits to the Elgar Peterson Arena after Christmas, including the last two games of the regular season. Spencer Bell against Justin Lees inside the faceoff dot back at Humboldt territory. Back to Chow. That one got knocked away by Lanthier. He'll try to get it back up front to Van Blerikom, but back there to break that up was McNutt. He'll play it ahead. Here's Ashton Paul. He'll race after it. Throws it to the front of the net for Anderson. Puck is bouncing. Lees back there trying to get a hold of it. Picked up here by Robertson, and he'll get it off the glass to Van Blerikom at center. Van Blerikom, a good move. Here's Lanthier. He's across the bomber line. Chow broke that one up along the boards to Ashton Paul. Can't get a stick free. He'll get it back a second time, though. Room now for Ashton Paul. Made a nifty move there. He's going to hang on to it. The Bombers try to figure out what they want to do to get up the ice here. Swings the pass to Anderson. Weigel, though, took it away from him. Get back to the Bomber blue line. Puck is picked up this time by Anderson and shoveled back in. And race in front of that is Olsson. They're not going to like that. And Constantino grabs a hold of him. And I think both Olsson and Constantino are going to get penalties here.
To be fair, on Olofsson, I saw the puck out of his glove just
yeah.
the time. You
yeah,
saw
I don't know
for
if they probably deserved
too.
The penalty, right?
Yeah, I saw the puck out of his glove a little bit. I thought that was pretty fair by Olofsson.
Even up call for sure. Olofsson will go for flip-flop. Constantino will go for Humboldt. But you know what? That means even more open ice now, 4-on-4 hockey.
Yeah, hey, and I don't think the Bombers are going to complain about that one bit.
Well, both these teams can skate. So coincidental minors being handed out. So 4-on-4 hockey here. The faceoff inside the Broncos zone to the right of Aiden Fisher. Silvestri getting set for the faceoff here against the Broncos. Amaral off the draw. The Broncos grab it quickly. This is Weigel to center. Back to Newlands. Newlands inside the football zone. They're offside again. And they'll blow that down with 11 and a half to go in the third period. So it's a 4-on-4. Is this the first time we've seen 4-on-4 hockey here tonight, isn't it?
I think it is, yeah. It looks like Noah Hool caught a break there. See, looks like he fell down a little bit. Could have been a big opportunity for the Humboldt Broncos there on that last rush.
Amaral against Silvestri outside the Bomber blue line. We're down to 11 and a half to go in the third period. Flint won a big power play goal here by Anderson. Has taken a 4-2 lead. Here's Leppert. Back to Walker. Walker tried to get across the line. Cook there to knock it away from him. Cook has it. He'll take a look. Swings the pass to Nuance. Nuance a good move around Silvestri. Nuance to center. Back across the bomber line. Newland's a chance. Gets it on target. The save made here by Laser Hume. Rebound gobbled up here by Harmon Laser Hume. Back of his own net. Look for Humboldt to be shooting as soon as they come across the bomber line. They need to get a couple of goals, and they're going to really press. Hool tripped up. Piccinito will pick it up. He gets runs into all kinds of trouble, but still gets it ahead. Now it's a chance for Niven. Niven down the wing across the line. Niven trying to get to the front of that. Push to the outside perfectly by Cook, nice defensive play. Niven runs into his guy, Van Blerikom. Here's Piccinito. Out front, open net! And McNutt couldn't shovel it in. He was left alone there. Piccinito again back of the goal. Throws it back out front, and Niven overskated it. Here comes Bell back to center. 10.5 to go. What a move by Bell. Bell hangs on his shot. Redirects off Tanchuk, goes to corner, throws it back out front to Miles. Miles, the team had a chance, gets a chance, and he'll fire that off the big bomber crest of Laser Hume, and he'll grab the rebound, starting to get a little feisty out there. Miles and Anderson mixing it up, but look for the Broncos to start gambling and start taking a lot of chances here with only 10-18 to play in the third period.
You know what, I think that's what they got to do. Even on the chances that they're shooting, the rebounds are there for the Humboldt Broncos. They just really have no one out in front. Bomber's doing a great job to clog up the middle, but they're getting the good opportunities, the good rebounds, but no one is there for the Broncos to clean them up.
Bell set for the faceoff against Anderson. Humboldt wins it back to Van Blerikom. Van Blerikom, that pass got blocked, and Anderson will regroup in his own zone, and I'm going to take a look here. He's circling all over the place. Boy, could this guy skate. Bumped off the plate, but got right back up. Good job by Van Blerikom. Here comes McDutt racing down the ice. What? Oh, good shot there, and he takes a high stick here. McDutt does from Miles. Unintentional. This might be a double minor here. Boy, did McDutt ever fool everybody with that trick shot there, including me. But Fisher was ready.
Remind me of that shot Bedard got a couple weeks ago, the no-look shot there. He was looking across to the other side and just flicked it on the net. But, yeah, I don't know why Fisher was ready for it.
Just 2 minutes, but puts one back on the power play. Real good opportunity to put Humboldt in all kinds of problems if they can score here. The Bomber power play is 2-for-5 tonight. Anderson's got both the power play markers. So power play 4-on-3 here for 14 seconds. Lots of open ice. Silvestri wins the faceoff, but Houle will see the puck go past him, and he'll go back to get it at his blue line. 4-on-3, Flint-Bond. Here's Houle quickly across the Humboldt line, going wide here on Cook. Noah Houle back of the net. He'll hang on to it. Here's Noah Houle. Plays it back to Justin Lees. Back out front to Houle. Houle, quick chance. Good save there, Fisher. The two penalized players, Olofsson and Constantino, make their way back to the box. It'll be a 5-on-4 now for a minute 41, and boy, Noah Houle looking extra smooth on that one.
Yeah, just his control with the puck and his comfortability looks unbelievable out there.
Bombers win the draw, right back to Jacob Bakker, but mishandles the puck. Almost lost a handle. Mamick, a chance, shorthanded, gets in. A great save by Laser Hume. That's the second time that Mamick's got a shorthanded breakaway in this game. He likes the penalty kill. Flint Flon maybe getting too cute here. They'll play it back to Bakker. Bakker, that one got blocked. Intercepted by Skogstad. Puck picked up by Flintbon back at center. They'll feed it back to Lees. A minute 11 to go in the power play. Here's Anderson to center. Carter Anderson. Couple nifty moves. Tripped up. Going to draw another penalty. 5-on-3, Flintbon. As Carter Anderson's tripped up. And they're going to get an excellent opportunity here, Austin. It's a 5-on-3 with a minute 4 to go in the first call and 9:01 remaining in the third period.
I think the Humboldt Broncos might be getting a little bit frustrated as time slowly dwindling down here. Maybe doing a little too much on defense, making some mistakes here and there, and then now they're going to pay for it.
Humboldt's going to call a timeout. We'll do the same. Bombers lead at 4-2. A chance to add more with a 5-on-3 power play coming up for the Whitney Forum here on 102.9 CFAR and FlintFlonOnline.com.
Attention.
Attention.
Clear.
Attention. On now at Creighton Furniture Appliance Center, it's the Whirlpool Black Friday sales event. Create the perfect home you want with appliances that fit what you need. It's the more you buy, the more you save Black Friday sales event. Buy one, save $100. Buy two, save $250. Buy three,
10 seconds,
$550. Because the more you buy, the more you save. Now's the time to take advantage of buying Whirlpool appliances. Shop Creighton Furniture and Whirlpool and save.
You're on.
All righty, 9:01 to go. Don't blame Scott Barney for calling the timeout. Smart move here by the veteran coach. Give his team a bit of a breather before this big 5-on-3 for football. And let's face it, the game really riding on this power play right now for him.
Oh, this could be do or die. If the Bombers score here, Rob, it may do it for them.
Silvestri in the face-off circle gets it back to Anderson. Quickly to Noah Houle. Back net for Bakker. Out front! What a save! Rebound! Silvestri will put her in! A gigantic stop by Fisher! But nobody picked up Silvestri. That took all of 4 seconds on the first penalty. So that means Flintbon's going to get a minute 56 on the second one. They're still on the power play. Alexi Silvestri out front. Nobody picked him up. His second of the night. And the Bombers all of a sudden up 5-2. And the onslaught continues here. 3 straight power play goals.
And there's only so much you can do on a 5-on-3. And Fisher did his best. He stopped the initial shot, but the rebound is right there for Alexi Silvestri. And wide open, he's going to get that every time.
So the Bombers right back on the power play. Here's Anderson quickly across the line. Lost the handle. Nuitz took it from him. Anderson got it back. Docked away. Set back down the ice as they get the call on the Silvestri goal. Justin Lees gets his second assist tonight. And another assist for Jacob Bakker. 4 for him. Jacob Bakker, 4 assists here tonight. Puck set down the ice, a bouncing ball, and Laser Hume will stop that. Anderson comes back to get it, and he'll play quickly back to center. Here's a give and go to Justin Lee. He's trying to break in. Got a weak shot away, and turn of the corner that time by Fisher. Puck lifted back down the ice. A minute five to go on the power play. 8:04 in the third period. Flint Fawn in front, 5-2. Three power play goals here, back to back to back. Here's the pass. McNutt. Knocked to the ice. Miles. He got a hold of it. McNutt pinned up along the board. Skogstad has it. He'll send it back to center. Here's Tanchuk. Feeds it back to Piccinino. Piccinino. Oh, big hit there as he steps into Costantino and swats into the ice. And he's going to get a penalty for that. He got the glove up in his face, so I guess a roughing call. Yep, Piccinino for the rough. And we'll be 4-on-4 here for 35 seconds, and Humboldt will get their fifth power play of the game. Justin Lees wants to get an explanation from the referee. He doesn't like it. Referee saying, and he got the glove up, or the elbow up, and caught him underneath the mask. So that's the reason for the penalty.
Yeah, we knew this game was going to get physical, Rob, and now we're starting to finally see that. Is I don't think it was as physical now in the first period as it is now. The Broncos down a few goals now, really starting to give it a bit, and Bombers starting to give it as well.
7.5 minutes remaining in the third period.
Oh, yeah, I think you might have brought the hand up there a little bit.
So 4-on-4 hockey here for 34 seconds, and the Broncos will go on the power play for the fifth time here tonight. A 5-2 Flint Fawn lead, but still plenty of time on the clock. 7:36 to go. Humboldt can get a goal, get right back in it here. They're still arguing the penalty. As Amaral will take the draw here against Silvestri, who's got a pair tonight. Off the faceoff, Amaral can't get the shot away. Cook will pinch in. He'll throw it in deep. Picked up in the corner that time by Amaral. Amaral goes in and takes a bit of a run here at Leper. Miller, back of the net, throws it out front, intercepted here by Silvestri. Silvestri will get a hold of it, and he'll send it down the ice. Here comes Bakker racing after it. But it is an icing call. And in 12 seconds, Humboldt will go back on the power play, but another big faceoff inside the football zone.
Bakker and Silvestri have been the tandem today to mess with. It just seems like they're honestly reading each other's minds with how they're moving on the ice today. It's been pretty beautiful to see.
Yeah, Bakker the last couple of games, really a lot of jump in his step. Bell against Silvestri faces off once again back in Flint Fawn territory. Left to Harmon Laser Hume off the draw. Lanthier can't knock it down. He better hurry up with Houle on top of him as he races back to get in his own zone. Throws it over to Weigel, but Weigel's not there. Houle intercepts it. Puck rolls off his stick, comes back to Silvestri at center. Humboldt now on the power play as Mamick races to the box. Here's Bakker, feeds it back to Leper. Leper's got it. He'll bring it across the line. Cork took it from him. He'll set it up for Weigel. Legal, the puck carrier to center, inside of the Bomber line. He's got it, he ripped it around the boards. Knocked down by Cork for Bell, back of the net. Throws it out front, nobody there. Down the ice it goes. Save is made here by Fisher, who'll play it ahead to Legal. 52 seconds to go in the power play, 6.5 remaining in the third period. Legal back inside his own zone, Niven watching him. And Legal's got to go back, and now he'll play it ahead here to Lanthier. Lanthier's got it. The center. Across the Bomber line, ripped it in. Bell will race after it. He'll let Cort take it instead. Cort's got it. To Bell, back of the net. Bounce it off the boards, back to point to Newlands. Newlands, quick chance. And never made it through here to Laser Hume. Hit somebody out front. Broncos get it back again. Newlands was calling for it. They'll go back to Weigel at the point. Back up front to Newlands. A hard drive. Blocked in front that time by McNutt. Back out front again. Newlands knocked it down, feeds it back up front. Here's corner chance, shoots it. Laser Hume stopped it, rebound. Goes to the corner. Olsson tries to pin up his guy. Works it back to Weigel. Shot through traffic again, knocked down by Amaral. And the penalty over. Out of the box, here's Piccinino. Wide open net, he's going to score. They pulled the goalie to go two men up. I didn't even notice it because all the play was down in the flip-flop zone. And Piccinino takes the pass, and he'll walk in, and he'll bury it. Did you notice that Humboldt net was empty?
No, I didn't even know. Obviously,
you've got to be paying attention to stuff like that.
I noticed as soon as Piccinino touched the puck, but...
How could you tell? I mean, I'm kidding. All the play was down on this end. But you know, I had no idea he pulled him.
But you know what? Who would have thought that play from Scott Barney? Honestly, if it would have worked out, would have been a genius play to be the two-man up. But obviously,
well, you had nothing to lose at this point.
No, exactly. So very smart play, right? Absolutely the right thing to do in that situation.
So Piccinino gets it out of the box. He takes the pass, and he gets his 10th of the year. The net was wide open.
Looks like Van Vlerkom's going off into the dressing room.
We haven't seen him here the last couple of shifts.
He just went off into the dressing room.
And they lost Connor Thu earlier. So Piccinino gets his 10th of the year. He's got the puck right now. Flintfun leads it 6-2. Piccinino takes a bit of a slash. He's got it back to center. He's going to work his way back. Got it back to Chow. McNutt will get the assist on that one. He was the one that fed him the puck. So Piccinino, two goals last night. A big goal here tonight. Flintfun in front by a score of 6-2. Mamick knocked that down the bomber line. He gets a quick chance and he'll fire that into the glove here. A laser hill. We got our media timeout. I guess we'll take a quick break as well. But boy, lots of offense for Flintfun here tonight. And once again, appear to have the Humboldt Broncos number.
Yeah, just crazy. You know what? You said the first 10 minutes of this game always seems to be where the Bombers struggle. But just like that, midway through the second period, game gets flipped around. And now it's a 6-2 game after leading 2-0. Just unbelievable here by the Flintfun Bombers.
Yeah, we'll stay here. Let's see what's happening out of town here tonight. The McDonald's out of town scoreboard. York has come back in that game against LaRange. It was 5-0. It's now 5-3.
Wow.
So 5-3 LaRange, about 7.5 to go in the third period. Melfort looks like they've beaten Notre Dame 7-2. Kindersley leads Estevan 5-3 in the third period. And oh, look out, Melville's tied things up with Battleford 3-3 late in the third period.
Oh, that'd be a good game to watch.
So some good games around the league here tonight. 6-2, Flintfun leads it here. Look at the shots though, Austin. Very close to 46-41.
Yeah, you know what? The Bombers usually out shooting teams, and I think they were almost up by, like, I think 14 or 15 at one point in this game, and then Humboldt had about a barrage, maybe like 9 or 10 unanswered shots, so very close in shots, but just funny how it turned out. When Bombers had more shots, they were down, and now the pretty even Humboldt Broncos are down.
Skogstad out to take the faceoff here against the Bombers. Olsson, less than 5 minutes to go in the third period. Flintfun in front, 6-2. As they've had a great third period here tonight. They've scored three times. Here's a chance for the Broncos, an on-man rush. They had Skogstad open out front. They couldn't get it to him. Mamick along the boards, gets away from Chow. Chow tried to hold him up there. Puck gets free! Gets a shot away. Good St. Laser-Hume. And look out, Laser-Hume comes over, takes a bit of a whack here at one of the Broncos. We got a penalty coming up here again. A holding penalty going to be called. And I don't know who it's going to. Aiden Chow, the defenseman. Aiden Chow will take the hold here. He had a hard time containing the speed. And Humboldt's power play number 6 there, Austin.
I wonder what happened there with Lasers Hume. You never really see him.
Well, I think there was a bit of a...
Don't really see him do that too often.
Melee in front of the net. I guess somebody must have tapped him, I guess. He didn't like it. Skogstad to take the faceoff against Silvestri. Humboldt another chance with the extra attacker. 4.5 minutes to play. Knocked down the blue line. Picked up here by McNutt. He'll back it off the boards. Fisher comes out. Bachler was cruising in there again, and he gets rid of it. Picked up here by Robertson. Cook gets it to center. Here's Cook. It's going to come back to Skogstad. Picked up and set back down the ice by Silvestri. Fisher will stop that, and that's where Robertson will take over. A minute and a half to go in the power play. Robertson skates it to center ice. Robertson inside the Flintfun zone. He'll bring it in deep. Leppard got a piece of that. They tie up at the corner. And grabbed here, fired down the ice. Nice defensive play that time by McNutt, who's had a good game. Once again, the Broncos to start off at square one. 1:14 to go in the power play. Now less than 4 minutes remaining in the third period. Cook having a hard time getting going here. Cook's got it. Plays it back to center, Newlands. Tapped that one ahead, but he couldn't get it across the line. Poole got back, and now it's taken away by Amaral. Back to Newlands, inside the Flintfun zone. Bombers feathered around the boards here for Leppard, but intercepted by Weagle. He'll knock it down. His quick shot. Deflected in the corner. Bombers bank it off the boards, and Weagle back to cut it off on the Broncos side of center. Here's Weagle. Back to Lanthier. Both Humboldt goals tonight, courtesy of him back in the opening period. Loses the handle. It comes back to Weagle. Weagle dishes it off. There's a quick goal. Oh, I thought it was in. Newlands at the side of the net. I think he thought it was in as well.
So did I.
Bombers dump it down the ice. 23 seconds remaining in the power play. That'll be an icing call. Boy, I thought Newlands put that in. He got in a picture-perfect spot, but fires it off the side of the net. And it'll stay out.
Yeah, it definitely looked like that one went in from up here. I thought maybe the goal judge didn't see it, but no, I guess it just went wide.
3 minutes remaining. 21 seconds remaining in the Humboldt power play. The Bombers leading this game by a score of 6-2. They win the draw. The puck will come back inside the Bomber blue line. There's McDutt. He'll get a hold of it, and he'll get it back to center. Constantino knocked it down. Constantino across the line. Loses the handle, and Lookman will flip it back to center. 5 seconds to go on the Bronco power play. Weigel again. Weigel back to center. Back inside the Flint Fawn zone. He'll skate it in deep. Weigel rip that around the board. Chow out of the box. The penalty is over. Humboldt 0-for-6 of the power play tonight. Jeez. Constantino feeds it to center ice. Grabbed by Weigel. Nguyen's still out there. He'll get a hold of it. Flip it back on target. And laser him forced to hang on to it because Amaral will skate to the front of the net. So 2:22 remaining. Flint Fawn about to pick up their 23rd win of the year. Third against Humboldt this year.
Yeah, you know what, Robin, like I said, looking back at the beginning of this game, you would have thought the Humboldt Broncos had the number on the Bombers, wanted the revenge, but I just...
Off the faceoff! Oh, Miller didn't miss by much. That's a good save there by Laser Hume. Bombers will dump it off the boards, back down the ice. Cook will give chase. That's an icing call. 2:11 to go. Bombers some momentum as they get set to make their way to LaRonge on Wednesday night. Haven't seen the ice well since basically the beginning of the year. That crazy home and home to start the season there.
I'm excited for those games, Rob. And then when we go down there on the 15th, I've never been there before, so it's going to be interesting.
Oh, nothing beats it. Paradise. Broncos with the faceoff. Miles knocked it down. He can't hold it in. And the Bombers will get it back to center. Miles, though, fights off a check, and Broncos try to go back to the attack. That hit Piccinito. The Bombers throw it back inside the Humboldt zone. Here's Piccinito. He knocked it down. He'll hang on to it. Some good moves along the boards here. They'll play it back to the right point to Laughlin. His shot. Wide of the mark. Chow will pinch in. Oh, look out. Strome took a run at him and hammered him to the ice. Broncos will ice it again. We're down to 1:37 remaining.
But I think
it's going to be interesting to see how this kind of game ends here tonight, I'm thinking.
Yeah, well, I can tell you already, Rob, I'm going to be excited for those two games at the end of the season between these two teams. I'm already looking forward to it. You know, like I said, score may be 6-2, and Bombers obviously are going to take the win here, but still a very exciting game and very, very tight.
Olofsson against Nazareth. The Bombers win the draw. This is Laughlin's shot. Strome blocked that. He'll grab the puck now, escape with it outside his own zone. Strome to center. Back across the Flint Flon line. Dropped it back there. They try to come back to Strome. That's broken up. Picked up here by Egan. They'll play it back to Laughlin. Laughlin to Egan. Egan takes it at center. Here's Egan quickly across the line. His shot. Blocked here by Robertson. Got it back. He fired it on target. Stick save made here by Fisher. Broncos looked it back to Skogstad. Quickly poked away from him. Egan again. Flipped it back up the ice. Mueller can't get to it. Skogstad does. Mamick stood up, but it comes back to Skogstad, and they'll pull that down for the offside. So 55 seconds to go. Lindblom, a impressive game here again. Impressive weekend here tonight. They put up 8 goals last night and 6 here tonight. 14 goals in 2 games. That ain't bad.
I knew I was almost thinking there we may see back-to-back 5-point games if Boffler could have gotten a goal tonight, but just couldn't get it done. But still, a 5-point game and a 4-point game by two different players. Very impressive.
Piccinino back out there for the faceoff. The Broncos grab it. Mamick stood up as he'll get the puck back inside the Flint Fawn zone. There's Chow. Around the boards, Arbery does get it out. Piccinino will pick it up. It's a 2-on-1 with Bridger. Piccinino walks in, shoots, and he ripped it wide. Looking for another 2-goal game tonight. Court back the other way. Feeds it back to Constantino. He rips that one over top of the net. 30 seconds to go. Piccinino can't knock it down. It comes in from the bomber net. Laughlin will lift it ahead. Piccinino again. Feeds it in for Arbery. 20 seconds remaining in the game. Arbery goes in there by himself, surrounded by 4 Broncos. Came out pretty good. Constantino, he'll pick it up. Played it ahead. Knocked down outside the line that time by Silvestri. Good game for him. 2 more goals tonight. Hughes, Silvestri getting worked over from the bench here. Look out.
Uh-oh.
1.7 seconds to go. Silvestri caught from the bench. Took a couple extra shots here from Constantino. Now Constantino gets a stick up on him. And they're just going to call it here and let the last couple seconds go.
Yeah, I think that's the right thing to do there.
Flint Fawn will pick up a big 6-2 victory. And will have to make their way to Humboldt for 3 games in the second half of the season. And I'm sure the Broncos will probably remember this one all too well.
Yeah, you know what? Like I said, they came in here looking real hot, and I'm sure going into the locker room in that first period, they thought they really had a chance here in this game today. But the Flint Flon Bombers just, I really don't know how to explain it, how they let these breakdowns happen in the first period and then come back and score six unanswered goals, Rob. I really don't know how they do it.
They probably don't either, but it seems to be working. So a big victory here for the Flint Flon Bombers tonight. Like Austin Mattis mentioned. Gave up the first two, but scored back with six unanswered here tonight. And in the process, we'll pick up their 23rd win of the year. So lots of stuff to get to from the Whitney Forum. Once again, the Flint Flon Bombers, a 6-2 victory. And pick up their 23rd win of the year here on 102.9 CFER and FlintFlonOnline.com. We'll take a break. We've got all the post-game show awards coming up. Our great Ted North post-game report, all from the Whitney Forum here tonight. Bombers victorious, 6-2 the final.
We're clear. Gosh darn it, we're in last place.
10, including the post game.
I want to go fast.
Okay. We'll get in there, Ricky Bobby, but first take this Jack's Links beef jerky.
Woohoo! This is one of the best damn experiences of my entire life.
And your Ricky Bobby takes his place in the Jack Links 500.
Arctic beverages and Jack Links beef jerky. Feed your wild side.
Northland Ford proudly supports the Flint Flon Bombers throughout the SJHL season. We know that the Bombers will play tough like the Ford F-150, the toughest truck on the market for over 40 years. Northland Ford helping the community cheer on the Bombers as they work to bring a championship to the best fans in the league, and they provide you with the best selection on their lot. In the North, for the North, Northland Ford, the dealership you tell your friends about.
Finding that just right present for everyone on your list can be challenging. So rather than go online or just guess what they want, visit the North of 53 Co-op. An already wrapped charcuterie or cheese box filled with artisan items is perfect for the person who already has everything. And for those on your list with a sweet tooth, tis the season for fruitcake, gingerbread, house kits, and more. Don't worry about things being the wrong size or color, because at the North of 53 Co-op, you're at home there.
Hudbay is proud to be a sponsor of this Bomber broadcast. Through bursaries, donations for hockey schools and clubs, community events, charities, and so much more, Hudbay has supported the Flint Flon community with their dedication and generosity for decades and continues to be a major
10 seconds.
Charities, events, and organizations. Hudbay thanks the people of Flint Flon and the surrounding communities for their continued support.
And you're up.
All righty, welcome back to Whitney Forum. The Flint Flon Bombers, a solid 6-2 victory here tonight. They spot the Broncos the first two goals and storm back with six unanswered to pick up the victory. Let's take a look at the final scoring summary here tonight. A good start for the Broncos, like you mentioned. Lanther gets a couple of goals in the opening period. It's Pip from Thu to open things up. 1:08 in. He'd come back just a few moments later, gets his second six of the year from Constantino at 6:11. 2-0 Humboldt. They had that big power play. The Bombers held them at bay, and a different game after that point. Noah Hull gets his six for Bachler Leopard tonight at 12:27. They get them on the board at 2-1 after one. Silvestri, a nice night for him as he picks up a beautiful goal, a recipient of a beautiful Jacob Bachler pass at the 5:54 mark. So Silvestri would score his 15th of the year to tie up the game. Eventual winner goes to Carter Anderson, who scores not once but twice on the power play. His 19th from Bachler and Hull at 12:20. Anderson again, number 20 from Lees and Bachler at 4:46 in the third period. And a couple of insurance goals by Silvestri, another power play marker. Second of the night, 16th of the year for him. Lees and Bachler, the assist at 12:07. The Piccinito into the empty net. Broncos going for broke. They had a power play, went 6-on-4 and couldn't get her done. The Piccinito takes the pass from McNutt behind the D, walks in, puts her home for the empty net, and he'll get his 10th of the year as the Bombers will take this one 6-2. Shots pretty close to that third period. Actually, the Broncos outshot Flint Flon in the third period, 16-12, but Flint Flon still the overall count tonight at 47-43. Power plays, big part of the story. The Bombers end up going 3-for-7. The Broncos finishing up 0-for-6. That's certainly one of the big factors in tonight's game.
Yeah, the power play all year for the Flint Flon Bombers has been unreal. And like we said, it was good yesterday, you know what, but obviously Yorkton Humboldt, two totally different teams. But yet again, the power play for the Bombers, so crucial in these games, not only to get goals, but it's a huge momentum thing for this Bombers team. Whenever they score on those power plays, it almost like it brings them back to life. It does that with most teams, but when you have 5 or 6, 7, 8 real top scorers here in this league who can score on any power player any night, it really just ramps up the team, and that made the huge difference tonight. And obviously, Carter Anderson, unbelievable today. Same with Alexi Silvestri. And so many other guys on this team tonight were just unbelievable, not only in the points, but just hustle-wise as well.
Yeah, full marks for the victory. Like we said, they're 23rd of the year. The Bombers improved to 23-1-2 and now have 48 points. And a lot of guys stepping up their play this weekend. They put up 8 against Yorkton last night, 6 here tonight. Pichinino, a great weekend. 2 goals yesterday, a big goal here tonight. Jacob Bachter, 4 assists in this game. Carter Anderson, 5 points last night, 2 more goals here tonight. So the big guns, first game for a while for Justin Lee's 9-game goal scoring streak comes to an end here tonight, though.
Yeah, it does. You're right. But you
still got a couple of assists and played good.
Yeah, we'll go. Can't complain at all. And you know what? To get a 9 games goal scoring streak is impressive enough to begin with. So yeah, Justin Lee's, but it just goes to show. You know what? I honestly think he maybe said his name 5 or 6 times tonight, and he was still able to do lots of good work out there for the Bombers. So they covered him well, but when you cover one of the best players out there, the Flin Flon Bombers, they can just go to the next guy. And after that guy, they go to the next guy, they go to the next guy. They can just keep going down the top 9, 10 guys, and they still have a great scoring opportunity. So this Flin Flon Bombers team, not only they got top scores, but they got some great depth, but also big credit to the Humble Broncos to come out strong. Real strong in this first period here. Put the Bombers on their heels, but like we said, Bombers have so many top scorers. It's just real difficult for any team right now to really score against them and keep it on them.
Harmon Lazerhum did what he had to do as well, as he picks up his league-leading 16th victory of the year. Like we mentioned, the SJHL goalie of the month, of course, for November. Best goals against, best save, and now 16 victories. What a year he's having. We'll take another break, come back with all the post-game show awards, and hopefully a great North post-game report here tonight, but a big win for the Bombers. Once again, 6-2 the final here at the Whitney Forum on 102.9 CFER and FlintFlonOnline.com.
It's your space.
Clear.
And Shane's understands that. With Samsung Appliances, Shane's has the product that will work for you.
That would, well, we're at 6 left now.
Do you want all,
so I'll leave us with 2 left.
A fridge because you don't like squeezing in your groceries. They have it. Or maybe you want something even smarter than you. An appliance that makes life easier and can help organize your family's day. Shane's and Samsung have it. What are you waiting for? Get to Shane's and shop Samsung Appliances. Because it's your space, your style, and they have it.
For a limited time at McDonald's, enjoy a tasty breakfast trio. Your choice of sausage, bacon, or chicken McMuffins with a hash brown and a small premium roast coffee for only $5 plus tax. Available before 11 a.m. at participating McDonald's restaurants in Canada. Plus, earn points on every order with the My McDonald's Rewards exclusively on the McDonald's app. Redeem points for your McDonald's favorites like McFlurries, McChickens, and more. Download the app today.
Hi, I'm Tom Eldridge, General Manager at Great North GM, and I am pumped about what we have in store for you this December. Come in and check out our Why Wait Till Christmas sale running the whole month of December. We're taking thousands of dollars off the hood of selected new and all of our pre-owned vehicles. Get up to $1,500 Christmas cash in your pocket when you purchase a brand new or pre-owned vehicle with the largest and widest selection of on-ground SUVs and trucks we've had in years. Hurry in and take advantage of our biggest sale of the year. Why Wait Till Christmas sale happening now till the end of the month, only at Great North GM.
Bailey Homes provides a ready-to-move home as unique as you and your family. From the expertise in the planning, the quality of the build, to the care of the move, let Bailey Homes make your dream home a reality. All customized to fit your needs, they allow you to take the stress out of home construction and spend more time making everlasting memories.
10 seconds.
Created with experiences in the north, visit bailey-homes.ca or call 204-903-5220.
You're on.
All righty, back here at the Whitney Forum. Could hardly wait to get Mike Reagan in here with his 2 cents on his team's 23rd victory of the year. Austin's all reared up, ready to go with the KFC 3-star selection, so let's have it. 3-2-1, who do you got?
All right, number 3, obviously Alexis Silvestri got that huge game-tying goal today. Great one for him, and then obviously later on he got that insurance goal on the power play. But just, we talked about his shot all night, his ability to shoot, and he was letting it rip tonight, got some great goals, and obviously some great opportunities as well. And that line with him, Vockler, and Niven really showed out tonight. So 3rd-star Alexis Silvestri. Moving on to star number 2, got to be Carter Anderson. Had the great game last night. But his ability on the power play, obviously, like I said, got those 4 goals last night, got the 2 today, but not only is he a great skater, great shooter, but his IQ is so high. His ability to play off the rebound, his ability to see through the lanes and see where those passes are coming through just to find the right angle on some of his shots is what really makes him stand out. And then obviously first star today, Jacob Vaucler with the 4 assists. We talked about him all night. You know, we were expecting him to have a huge game. And I don't know, Rob, I think you got a little telepathy going on because you were calling it from the beginning of the game. You said he was going to have a good game. He was going to pop off a little bit. And absolutely,
well,
he looked
really good last night.
He did, and he's really been stepping it up. And you know what? We talked about how many scores this Bomber team has, and he's not going to get a goal every single night. But when he got 4 assists, you know what? It's a great game for him, and he absolutely deserved that first star tonight. So those are the 3 stars. Jacob Vaucler, number one, with the 4 assists.
The Brent Krucholski Warrior of the Game, who have you got picked?
Oh, you know what, Rob? We talked about him all night, too, and he's going to be a great addition to this Bomber team, and that's got to be Luke Leper. Not only was he huge on that very first goal there on the assist to keep it in the zone, but also about 2 or 3 times today when he's caught in one-on-one situations, great stick, great IQ to sit back and just play the puck, see what's going to happen, and break up Humboldt on those opportunities. And just a huge hustle, great IQ on him, so he's got to be the Warrior of the Game. Got the assist tonight. Not a big points guy so far on this team, but I think down the line, if he stays here, got a huge opportunity to do that because his IQ and work ethic is just already there.
All right, job well done. We'll let Mike slide in here, and then we'll take a quick wrap. We'll take a quick break after that and come back with a wrap-up here. Get ready for LaRange on Wednesday. So, Mike, you spotted the Broncos 2 quick goals here tonight, but a couple of keys for me. They had the power play. You killed it. They could have went up 3-0. You killed the penalty, and then you get a goal right back from Noah Hull. You were able to sneak one in from the blue line. So the first key was killing that power play and then getting that quick goal to answer those two quick goals.
Yeah, that was a dangerous one. You know, you're down 2-0, and you give them a power play, and that can really make it difficult to come back. But, you know, our penalty kill's been unbelievable all year. And, you know, they continue to come up with big kills at big times. So, you know, and the nice thing is about Noah's goal there, like we moved the puck real quick and he just got a shot off quickly. You know, we talked about our guys sometimes overhandle the puck and, you know, always are looking for something better. Sometimes you just got to put pucks to the net. You know, you catch the goalie off guard. You don't let him set. And that got us going.
It certainly did. And the power play tonight, Mike, boy, what a weekend for Carter Anderson. 5 points last night, 2 goals here tonight, and boy, I don't know if anybody can shoot the puck as well as he gets. He has that beautiful, just quick release, and actually, I got to give Aiden Fisher a lot of credit. He stopped him the first time, and that's a tough save, and he went right back to the same spot, and he beat him. He put a little bit more along the post the second time, but he really could have had really 3 tonight. Fisher made a real big save off him, and then he gets the next chance, he scores, but he gets too many chances tonight, he's going to bury it, and that's what he does.
Well, and we talk about with the power play that, you know, at the beginning of the year, they were just kind of relying on their skill. And then when we acquired Andy, it kind of set everything up. We had Justin on the flank. We moved him down net front. He does such a good job there. You know, and then obviously Andy's got that shot. Kind of reminds me of Branson Hine. Remember, he could rip the puck from there, that one-timer spot. But, yeah, and Andy loves to. And I told him, you're our shooter. Like, just shoot pucks. And, you know, and then we've got a lot of other options, too. You know, we had the down-low play that, you know, ends up in the back of the net. Andy finds the rebound. It slides off Justin's stick there a little bit. But, you know, our power play is clicking right now, and they look real good. And, you know, it's our specialty teams that have been huge for us here over the last in this stretch. But, you know, I thought that Laser came up with some big saves there in the second period when Humboldt was pressing, and those,
he was dialed in for sure.
Those definitely, you know, allow the guys to keep going here and keep that momentum. So I was really happy with our effort after the first 10 minutes of the game.
And 5-on-5 tonight, maybe even the last 2 games, would be hard-pressed to find a better player than Piccinino.
Yeah, Peach has been really good since he got back in the lineup here. He's feeling it, you know, really good to see. You know, we think that we've got 4 lines that contribute in the offensive zone, but also play really tight D. You know, that's something that we've really stressed to the guys, is that you win because of defense, and if you play good defense, you're gonna have real good offense. So you know, everything starts from our net out, and we've been pretty good there.
Before we talk about LaRange on Wednesday, Mike, we should throw a shout out to Luke Leper tonight. You know, Austin gave him the Warrior of the Game. He was instrumental on that first goal. He went down along the boards, battled to keep the puck in.
Second, third efforts, you know, unbelievable. Leps is a very good, sneaky defenseman. People probably don't give him enough credit, and that's fine. I think that he's going to be one hell of a D-man in this league for years to come here, and we're very lucky to have him.
Played a great game tonight, Mike. Now you look forward to LaRange. You haven't seen him for a while. They've been struggling. They were winning tonight the last time I checked, but it was tight. But nonetheless, your first trip to the Mel Hedlund here in a while.
Yeah, no, we're going to just enjoy this weekend here. We played three games in four nights. You know, we win all three games here against some good teams, and we're looking forward to, you know, the next challenge. It's kind of like that's what we talk about all the time is every day is a new challenge, and, you know, we've been passing a lot of the tests here, so, you know, there's going to be another one going into the Mel. That's not an easy place to play. They just made a huge trade and, you know, probably feeling a little momentum. Sometimes you get a little shot in the arm after a trade, whether it's, you know, whether you're trading a good player or not, you know, like you got two new guys coming in the lineup and they're going to inject some energy.
Was it the pace is strong than it was when you played these guys a couple weeks ago?
I don't know. I thought it started slow. I thought
well,
that
it was hard to get flow. There's so many whistles.
Yeah,
off the
I thought that there was like almost not a nervous energy in the building, but it was like it took a bit for us to get going, and I don't know why that was. You know, you get put on your heels there early on. You know, a couple defensive miscues that we went over in video today, actually, and then like you said, a lot of whistles. You know, and these are two teams that have a lot of horses that want to run. So, you know, it'd be nice if there wasn't as many whistles, but you play the game that's in front of you, and you can't force games, and you got to win games differently.
Well, and I mean, tonight, like, you spot a really good home. It's one thing to give a leave it up to Yorkton or Melville, but another thing to give up a lead to Humboldt. But the team just seems to, they don't never seem to panic. I mean, they give up a couple of goals. There's still lots of time left. They just slowly but surely start to get their momentum, and once the momentum starts, it's been pretty hard to stop.
Yeah, we believe in our ability, you know, and we believe in ourselves, and that's a big thing. There's a lot of confidence on that bench. There's a lot of confidence in that dressing room. You guys have worked hard. You know, they're committed, and they want to win. You know, we got a very competitive group there, and I think that's important. You want guys that just hate losing. You know, we kind of talk about sometimes that we want guys that are, when they're playing their grandma in checkers, they want to beat her, you know, and that sort of thing. You know, you don't let off an inch. So I think that's important, just to have that competitive nature. So if any of the guys' grandmas are listening at Christmas time, play them in checkers, see how it goes.
Big win tonight. Great weekend, Mike. Congratulations. Good luck in LaRange on Wednesday night.
Thanks very much, Hardy.
Mike Reagan, the head coach of the Bombers. We'll take one last break and come back with a wrap-up for the Whitney Forum here on 102.9 CFER and FlintFlawOnline.com.
How does KFC make their original recipe chicken taste so good? Their trained cooks handle premium grain-fed Canadian chicken for their original recipe on the bone, which is raised without any hormones in a secret recipe of 11 herbs and spices. They use only trans-fat-free Canadian canola oil to cut the saturated fat in the food without sacrificing taste, and it's cooked in small batches throughout the day. This ensures that the chicken is always fresh, just the way the Colonel wanted it. KFC. So good.
Whether you like that morning sunshine or prefer to keep the sunlight outside, the power is yours with Shade-O-Matic blinds at Jim's Custom Doors and Windows. With tons of different styles, materials, colors, and purpose, get the Shade-O-Matic blinds that suit your look. And all shutters are custom built to ensure a perfect fit every time.
10 seconds.
There's a reason they're Canada's leading supplier of premium window coverings, Shade-O-Matic blinds at Jim's Custom Doors and Windows.
You're on.
I hear you. We're back at the Whitney Forum with a wrap-up, Austin Manis. Quickly before we wrap things up, the McDonald's out-of-town scoreboard, the MJHL here tonight. Selkirk, a 6-1 win against Swan Valley. Dauphin beat Steinbach 4-1. It was Weiwei losing to Portage 4-2, and Nipua doubled up on the free 6-3. SJHL scores back-to-back losses for the Battleford Stars as they fall in overtime here tonight to the Melville Millionaires. It was 3-0 Battleford. Melville Storms back with 4 to win it in overtime 4-3. Kindersley holds off Estevan tonight 5-4. LaRange holds off Yorkton 6-4. It was a 5-0 lead there. The Terriers did come back. And then we got Melford taking it to Notre Dame tonight by a final of 7-2. So that's pretty much going to do it for our broadcast tonight. Any closing comments there, Austin?
Just that the Flin Flon Bombers continue to impress me, Rob. You know what? At the start of every game, I'm kind of like, you know what? It may be the game where they get blown out tonight, and then we get into the second period, and they absolutely turn it around. So every single game, they just continue to impress me with their ability to deal with diversity. And being down in some against really good teams, like I said, it's one thing being down. No disrespect to Yorkton, but they're a very different club than this Humboldt team. You know, when you're down 3-0 in Yorkton, you got that feeling you may have a chance, but Against Humble, it's a little different, but even today, great showing by the Bombers, but also got to give big credit. Fisher, even though we let six in today, still played unreal for the most part. Obviously, most of the goals came from the power play for us, and just a great hockey game to watch, fast-paced, physical, and just like we said, I'm happy to watch these games at the end of the season and the one we got here. I think the next one is in February, I think we play them, right? So
yeah.
Very exciting series between these two teams all the time, and if we play them in the playoffs, which I'm assuming we will, another exciting game is going to happen as well.
So Flint Flon wins at 6-2. They improve their overall record again to 23-1-2 and now have won all three against Humboldt this year. Bombers continue their fine play against the Broncos, now 11-5-1-2. In all the head-to-head matchups regular season the last 5 years. But they'll savor this one and get ready for the LaRange Ice Wolves making their trek to the Mel Hegland for the first time since September. That'll happen on Wednesday. We'll be on the air with the Great North GM Coaches Show at 7:10. Drop of the puck from the Mel Hegland beginning at 7:30. So, again, big thanks to Austin Manis, color commentator tonight. Mike Reagan, Scott Barney, their comments before and after the game. Adam McNutt was our Northland Ford Flint Flon Bomber player profile. And great to catch up with Roy McGoran, of course, from the Broncos and SJHL once again in the second intermission tonight. And, of course, our operator-in-chief, Raphael Sarai, back in CF Air Control. Bombers win 6-2. Good night from the Whitney Farm.